This is so advanced.
Okay, well, this is kind of crashing my computer, so for the sake of speed, I'm just going to send it to the debaters, and we can flash right around.
Yeah.
How does it... It doesn't even make sense. Maybe jumping?
The tubes are clogged. That email went right through. The other one is having no such luck. Well, it's arriving. The tubes are taking their time. Things are flowing.
What's going on? What's going on?
Here, you
want
to just...
I only do dial-up, actually. Is sort of the thing.
Is everyone...
Yeah.
No. We can just take...
Dial-up is over.
I
think that's
what's
happening.
Did you all get it?
Can I see that? This paper right there.
Wait, so it really wasn't the number of people on the email chain?
Yeah, for sure.
Like,
the second one
got it.
I don't know if that's the reason.
It might have been one of the emails. I don't know. Okay, is everyone ready? Let's get this started.
Yeah, we're good.
I think our roommates are watching, which is cool. Anyways. I always get shakes before the drop. After we had dreaded dropping the project, young opportunity leader inspected us. He shouted, I just want to remind you, apes and each and every one of you has cost the government better than half a million, so bring it back. We can spare you. We can't spare that fancy suit you're wearing. This is just a raid, not a battle. It's a demonstration of firepower and frightfulness. Our mission is to let the enemy know that we could have destroyed their city, but didn't. In the mobile infantry, everybody drops and everybody fights. I jump back on the building nearest me, raised the launcher to my shoulder, found the target, and pulled the trigger. And my first rocket hit that unmistakable brilliance of an atomic explosion that locked me. Looked like a good job to me, much of the city was burning. One man absent, I reported to Johnson right that moment. I was feeling unusually expendable, almost expended because I was hearing the sweetest sound in the universe, the beacon. Walk away to another trooper, not the mobile infantry. I found Ace standing over him. There was actually a hole in his armor and blood coming out. We carry him, Ace said grimly. Three jumps got us to the boat. We got him in and we closed it up. Flores died on the way up. This excerpt from Robert Heinlein's novel Starship Troopers describes a human attack on the Skinnies, an alien species allied with humanity's greatest enemies, the Arachnids. Just as American soldiers today rely on dazzling technological superiority over impoverished low-tech enemies, troops wearing robotic armor execute a raid, not quite a war, but a limited intervention designed to show what humanity is capable of, much like the United States intervention in Libya. This is not only a small part of a much broader conflict, but the consequences are real. Johnny Rico, the hero of Starship Troopers, kills untold numbers of civilians in scenes with flamethrowers, grenades, and nuclear warheads. There is no remorse for the alien enemy. Johnny won't leave his wounded comrades behind. Enemy lives may be cheap, but the mobile infantry looks out for its own. The soldiers of our mobile infantry are all volunteers. In a society of Starship Troopers, citizenship is a privilege, not a right. No one can vote or participate in politics without first serving in the in combat. Heinlein's novel has been criticized as thinly veiled fascist propaganda with the alien enemies or standards for America's communist enemies in Asia. At the height of the Cold War, Heinlein seemed to be in favor of restricting democracy and giving up the concept of equality. There's another reading, however. Intervention might happen in the world of Starship Troopers, but at least the decisions are made by the same people who bear the cost in modern America. Civilians get behind intervention like the war in Libya because they are isolated from the true sacrifice of war. Hyperreal culture, mass media distortion makes wars and claims seem clean. Even humanitarian Heinlein's policy might be extreme, but the story of Starship Troopers provides a corrective to this armchair militarism, forcing us to rethink constant imperial interventions to the series 11. The world is a hyper-technological state of acceptance. Starship Troopers struck the alarming chord for this very reason. Foreclosure of anti-war distance, limits, weapons, and technology. Starship Troopers is particularly relevant, not considering the enthusiasm of military inventions, living chaos in between. The civilians best the military intervene, the military men and women who bear the cost of such invention presents an ethical breach with the democratic process. Heinlein sets up his most controversial claim that civilian military divides the citizens to be reserved for those who serve in the military. I told him, except the personal responsibility to safety, body politics, citizen does not. The barbarian's personal responsibility and life is not only willing to assume the physical risk of political decision, but also not understanding what those risks entail. Decision makers must understand the meaning of those risks to experience result. Is not a citizenry of hawk, for a citizenry who understands the inescapable bounds of warfare, the technological abstraction of war is given an ignorant pop, the idea that no fly zones exert the bounds of warfare and restore. Those are not the fantasy of those who have bought, but those who have never seen the simulacron cable news. This is disconnect and only create or be responsible and uninformed disinterested public continues to live through the euphemism created under the guise of humanitarianism and technological abstraction. Here we return to the question of Bolivia, whether or not we subscribe to Heinlein's theories and decisions. This moral responsibility does warrant consideration for all. Is jingoism Heinlein's not? Let's forget the balance of wars. Inescapable soldiers on the ground will pay the cost, and these interventions are not harmless. Heinlein's space war, the cause of use of nuclear weapons will be brought on by the confluence of hyperreal mass media saturation, cost for militarism, the endless manufacture of new threats and new interventions can only end in extinction. Croker 6. Confrontation by direct challenge to the empire of global American states without self-doxological terrorism, relying on logical power, apprehend threats to the internal security of the American homeland, state security forces of the island, and mute most domestic political sentiment to silence this. It's the end of any form of empire, the beginning of another empire, blades beat and violence, Pentagon wishing now conventionalized nuclear weapons stage, and we found a separate global nuclear holocaust, the final accident, declining form of power, American military strategic plans have already created a conceptual framework for coming age of galactic warfare, extraterrestrial satellite-based warfare in the darkness of space. Thus the plan, the United States federal government should substantially increase statutory restrictions on war powers authority of the President of the United States to introduce a voluntary United States Armed Forces into hostilities. Our reading of Starship Troopers can challenge the ontological and epistemological certainty world politics. This deployment of any story can be an ironic challenge to the anti-politics of militarism. Whitehall 3. Starship Troopers can be read as literature deeply investing, examining the political security of the agency of the beyond but open world plus political interpretation. Starship Troopers examines the political security and ontological epistemological world conceals the irony. Starship Troopers makes us see one set of protests and all those practices of world politics, but because irony targets the dominant structure of intelligibility, irony structures always run the risk of being in branded solipsistic irony being championed the device works against the domination of epistemological ontological practice of will as policy uses irony operates by affirming the contestable character's own projection that over irony forces the way beyond its ritualized practice of overturning modern policy that opens the natural secure world to a plurality of alternative interpretation and destroying the hyper-real fiction the media of militarist society requires us to tell stories that are impossibly false science fiction is the gift the system can receive only by destroying itself. 4. Science fiction is the fiction of real politics from technology right now in your face. What's more fictional than 24 hours? Total information. Where does speak to learn how to make the reality of events more fictional than fiction? Everything that is obscenely visible, controlled, and advanced by models disguise the absence of everything real. Hyperfaxes to information overload and ends universal testing when something truth has been murdered as death. Math becomes true to you, requires something more dangerous than fiction. How do we get the more fictional than fiction? We need to give a worldly the gift which cannot respond except by its own death. What's to destroy the fiction of the hyperfactual and the gift of being more monstrous fiction? And the abstract of imagination is a prerequisite to breaking down a hyper-militarized fascist politics gray in 94. Military future world cannot see any clear line between science fiction wars, such as not make for sound military policy, contributes to the incredible public misconception about international conflict, the inevitability of war, is really just an elaborate construction of real change, comes from the imagination, most of all, ideal, predetermined, and the ending of imagination, generating new ones, cultural imagination, certainly a necessity for peace. The point of our advocacy is to cultivate a more responsible model of democracy. Science fiction is critical to a functioning participatory democracy because it educates citizens about the crucial role of technology in modern politics, breaking thorn in three. Science is often portrayed in the United States to be dulled with distractions. We need to recognize they may wish to acquire a degree of scientific literacy, and all of science is a fundamental part of participatory democracy. We live in society under the penalty, since change requires a sequence of vital decisions. Science fiction exists as a cultural phenomenon that encourages the match reinterpreting the world. The genre of science fiction has always been used as an example of the relationship between science, technology, and society, since many people's main sources of science and through science fiction portrayals of science and intimate activity of crucial importance for the public's attitude towards science and creative engagement with political decision making, creative, it's critical human survival standard and sense of control, political decision making, enhanced fear and fear, technological experts, gradual toss, material research, plays all life under the precarious position when we need more creativity. Notes, we find the region and close non solution, we find alienation, even more hostile, the political process, flash move, apocalyptic rhetoric, no less threatening merely as any metaphor, slow death, fall, living through environmental degradation, the irradiation of the planet, or the descent into political and ethical barbarism, collecting the threats of our unified perspective based on diverse viewpoints, we must fight the colonization of the life world and the order to survive at all, the willingness to facilitate organized democratic deliberation in one way to resist this colonization, and all politics is fictional, imagination is a central component of representation, our affirmative really exposes this truth, Friedman 2K. No text can be adequately described in terms of one genre. We may describe a particular text of science fiction of cognitive strength with dominant generic tendency. There is no text in which scientific tendency is not altogether absent. Tendency, the precondition for causation of fictionality, but the construction of an alternate world is the very definition of fiction. Cognition as a stranger is structurally crucial to the possibility of fiction, even the representation in the first place. In world politics and really science fiction, our representation of reality exists as cultural products inscribed as a text as the world is in three. Realities we know are discursive products because the real is never wholly present for us. We lose something when we think of the representation of mimetic science fiction, not to the window onto the already pre-existing world. Science fiction checks the part of the process of the world politics themselves. We can read the real is itself a social and cultural product. We read the real as a text to disclose an aspect of human cognitive fugitive in the world of the classic inscription into static reality. World politics then is itself a cultural product and cognitive estrangement is cordis. Court of science fiction booth at all nine. Stephen's discussion of science fiction and literary genre includes the concept of cognitive strength and science fiction literary genre is made formal by some imagined framework called the alternative to the office empirical environment. Modal narratives can also be precisely so characters cognitive strength and therefore requires operating within a liminal zone where knowledge is partially placed with too much emphasis and possibilities what would determine the fallacy of mimesis' major role in modal narratives draw attention to the differences between the actual world and various possible worlds not to actualize the possible and the overly strong insistence on plausibility is the always to miss the point anyone believes in reality. The counterfeit world is insane. The wholly alternate universe subgenre is exactly the opposite direction of the suburban belief in what is accepted as real imagining other worlds becomes to be upon our conditions in a new incredible life, the rhetorical cognitive strength and satisfies the desire to understand something more than the given data or presentative experience must necessarily be accomplished through a narrative because the thought experiment is that critique must necessarily be inscribed in text to be mobilized in a story awareness modalities and essential aspects of scenario planning and organizational and policy foresight in a universe which remains beyond the scope of foresight to predict and behooves us not to strive towards these inacceptable mimetic goals but instead to encourage reflexive and self-critical approach which might elicit positive policy actions policy of possible worlds approach place less emphasis on the fallacy of mimesis and fictional imagination is the beginning of a true politics, a heuristic device that subverts hegemonic discourse and mobilizes activism, break pattern 9. Utopias and permits are political thought is also presupposed to any political critique. Utopias and end state of is not an end state of perfection. The dominant misconception of utopia is a perfect static system has long been redundant within utopian system unfortunately persists. In common parlance, believe blueprint utopias and unnecessary restricting the temporal closure of the productive aspect of utopia is a very active imagination. Without this initial act of imagination, we know the movement. You actually can change the world. A precursor to doing so, utopian imagination represents a liberated zone from which anti-hegemonic force can attack the present move boldly beyond emancipated future utility. Utopianism can be also printed, can not only critically subvert current ways of existence by revealing them as a reductio ad absurdum, but also vindicates the imagination as something better as a productive pre-political act towards fantasizing power of the imagination. Utopian can oppose the affirmative culture maintained by dominant ideologies to become a proto-political act. Utopia should no longer be assumed to be a blueprint but a critical imaginary that acts as a heuristic device to reveal the fissures in existing reality. This is the preferred site of resistance. Only science fiction can engage in holistic critique. Moyle and 2K. Within the realm of science fiction, dystopian term critically voiced the fears and anxieties of new and identity. Post-industrial societies, critical dystopias, deconstruct tradition, reconstruct dystopias, negate static ideals, preserve radical life, and create space in which opposition can be articulated and received. The strategy of the level of form enabling this text to challenge the present situation by creating the local consistent hope and subversive tension of critical dystopia opens the space. When opposition for these groups of subject position, hegemonic discourse does not contemplate critical dystopias go on to explore the ways that social radicals not shaped by the impulse of human self-determination, rather than ones constructed by a destructive system of logic of a profit only for a few dystopias. New dystopias, a dialectic of the transcending in the moment of post structural critique and identity-based micropolitical wheels turn again new historical objections upon an anticipatory machine and the new context of critical dystopias persist. Hegemonic and oppositional orthodoxy, even as they refunction a larger, more totalizing critique of the political economy itself, they in drive a space for a new form of political opposition based in different than multiple we now can mechanically organize in a fully democratic alliance. Politics not only critique the present system, but also transform right. Beyond the limitation of both the radical micropolitics and compromise central solutions. The new dystopias were one of the preferred sites of resistance, critical dystopian position, the politics imagination. The political imagination of the world large realm, democratically unified alliance, possibly all that seems to remain, a contemporary theoretical practice of open resistance, closure, and adults revive, and privileges, totalizing analysis, they consider the entire political economic system transformed into policies that are evil, both rupturing that system, forging radical alternative in its place, and science fiction emerges for political mobilization, Moylan 2K. An inherent part of critical Soviet sexual resistance lies in mediation, the very act of writing by, for granting the productive technical signifier the point of the utopia, but also emphasizing the imaginative process that helps produce a political movement towards the utopian rising critical Soviet can provide, and the inspiration for counter-political public sphere that can become a ground for overt political mobilization, necessary forming part of all opposition, and science fiction hones our decision-making skills, hunting in 75. By engaging in the act of imagining the unknown, science fiction prepares for the future, these are future alters, reframing, claiming literal prophecy, and never agree. But science fiction trans agree to anticipate the unexpected prime, pursue godless, and stability, engage in particular set of problems to which science fiction gives rise, and in which we belong not to the future, but to the present, science fiction tame the threat of the future.
Can't read anything else. Pro 6.
I'm gonna take a second to reference reading this.
Oof. That was an optimistic one, I see.
Yeah, you know. I like to think the best of the bread.
That is a serious mistake. Yeah, that is like one more G's than you're making now. Those 20 seconds. If we win that the federal government should not increase restrictions on the authority of the President of the U.S. to introduce a voluntary USAF into hostilities, do we win? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so you'll defend the implementation of the plan?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Kind of shocked. Your Whitehall evidence says that let's get on that murmur.
It's
what did
science
you say?
Science fiction, dude.
We'll defend the implementation in the world that we have so described.
It would make literally no sense for you to read a DA to now and then say that somehow links to our affirmative.
So if we say, so for example, your gray evidence is like, the inevitability of war is just an elaborate construction. Cultural imagination is certainly necessary for peace. If we say that pacifism is bad, are you going to say that your framework obviates that?
If you win that peace is bad, I think that you probably do.
No, not peace. Not peace. The strategy of pacifism of achieving peace.
I don't think
we're not pacifism, so I think you'd have to win
this
that
evidence has, okay, well then what does this evidence mean by the inevitability
saying
of war?
Saying militarism bad is not the same thing as saying pacifism.
We will probably defend
this evidence says that the inevitability of war is just an elaborate construction. How do we break that down?
By science fiction? What?
By assuming that there is a possible world where war is not inevitable.
You're willing to give you a link, I just don't even know what it is.
Your evidence is like, dystopias negate static ideals and create a space in which opposition can be articulated.
Yes.
What is clouding the space now, and what have you articulated?
There is a hypersaturation, our evidence talks about, of news, of information, of statistics, of political processes. Our point is that dystopia interrupts that sort of oversaturation, becomes a story
okay.
that the system
so,
can't handle.
Fox News throws out shit 24/7.
Yes.
Science fiction does what to stop that?
It subverts that process by giving it a story that cannot be integrated.
I mean,
back
I think it's
the
important.
You think Fox News?
Sorry.
Like,
I think it's important to contextualize it to this.
Half
space.
Of Fox News is already science
yeah,
fiction.
Yeah, Fox News is not hanging out.
Yeah, true.
It's not hanging out here. Our argument is that policy debate, in and of itself, is a form of shitty science fiction. We need to recognize that by giving the system a gift
okay.
that it cannot
okay.
accept without its own destruction.
Okay, so is your argument that, like, you would result in Georgetown not reading plans anymore? Is that, like, the destruction?
I certainly hope Arst is
no, like, what is the destruction of debate? What is the destruction of normal policy debate that you're calling for? What does that
I mean, it's a disarticulation within this space, obviously.
No. Yeah, but what, okay, what
happen,
does,
how
okay, I know you're disarticulating the topic. What is the alternative? Like, what should debate
what do you
look
mean
like?
The alt?
What should debate look
we
like?
We think debate should be open to different temporalities and different questions.
Okay,
we think debate
so
should be
so the app says that, and then the neg accepts that framework, and what happens next?
Then you can negate what?
I think debate becomes vastly more open.
No,
to
like seriously,
ways
if the 1AC
topics.
Is like we should be open to future temporalities, and the negative is like we'll accept that framework.
Well,
what should the negative say?
Our argument is that science fiction should be included in debate, and that the 1AC's production of science fiction was a good way of getting citizens to engage with the question of war powers. I don't understand the premise of your question. If you agreed with us, then yeah, I mean, like we would be happy about it, and then we would win.
All right. I want to take a little more second. I want to take a little more prep.
It's okay.
Well, what is the role of the ballot?
To vote for whoever has the best plan or whatever.
Whoever has the best plan.
Why? One more question. Why vote out?
We had a pretty long conversation about that just now. Do you want me to like reiterate the we said?
Yeah, not really. Okay. Well, actually, I do.
Thank you. know. That's a good question, actually.
Where do you want to
put it?
Oh, we definitely do. I totally forgot about this game.
I got
wait, they left. Or some, yeah.
Are you going to break the multitude of tubes?
Yeah.
Yeah. Are you going to send it
back?
I'm sorry.
It's
a
I mean, what is time really? Rounding up? Or just round to like the nearest kind of even?
Reaffirm a utopia of hegemony. There are restrictions on executive flexibility or bad lead and I'm proliferation ensure that conventional wars may have limited scope and duration. The Nazi actors must be defined as funded that the Constitution does not sign the scope of government system, inherent under terrorists, the Elijah's rogues, and proliferation weapons, nuclear, and others. Constitution, the Constitution, the Constitution is now over. The adherent to this ideology will get the U.S. in a war struggle for survival and for the generation of war group reaction to stopping the enemy or keys to victory to win. We should operate a fast time with an administration, slow working Congress not have the ability to deal with fast emergency situations. The executive must have the ability to operate because only the executive is capable of swift action necessary to win for the generation of conflicts. Hegemony sells great power to nuclear war. The little side and level closing gaps in the U.S. and travel to intensify the deal. Well, little confidence ready to make terms on terror will do respond to crisis because of recessation in August. Peace and very powers of the Union here. Resolution is multiple questions around the stable resulting in a crisis of age war. With everything consequences, there is no harm to be there behind possibly all. Conflict next stop is topicality. A interpretation violation of the affirmative should defend the desirability of topical government action. Most critical of A agent and verb indicates the debate about hypothetical government action. Erickson 3. Each topic contains agent during the act of U.S. The dominant policy agent subject verb should urge action. Should adopt to policy and action through governmental means investigation, direct limitation, action strategy, entire debate about whether something ought to occur resolved. Legislative departure and one resolve, a determination or decision to resolve is used to evidence the fact that policy may resolve by adopting resolutions by legislative body should require defending federal action and implementation. The 809 should issue special obligation authority, appears to be favor interpretation in the imperative sense of word, not being much centered in court, not the word conveys obligation of discretion. Substantial means in full existence and in effect means the plan must be tangible. Increase in restrictions, word and phrase 64, the word substantial means in full existence, not merely to be, but real at the present time. USAF is DOD components, Barlocks, and 13 United States Armed Forces used to know only the regular components of the Army, Navy, Armed Forces. Marine Corps and the Coast Guard are general subject of debate is not enough. Debate requires a specific point of difference in order to promote effective exchange, cyber, and freely 13. Debate is a means of settling differences, so there must be controversy before anyone can debate. Everyone is going to be valued only for debate. Controversy and be rested in the class for there's no debate going off news factors without clear advantage of your question. Everybody think that in terms of your address conversation about topic area, this debate is likely to be emotional intense. However, it's not likely to be productive without people question identifying the line. The organizing side to be resolved likely controversy to rest such that all parties share an understanding objective. This debate will still in comparison of competing argumentation leading to factors, debate understanding results on post delusion, poor decision, attention. Opportunity for resolution and distress, of course, argumentation occurs in a range of something it may not in a harmonious question. However, by definition, debate requires judgment on proposition pride, focus for discussion guides, decision, proposition pride, essential guidance for preparation. The discourse, then decision to be made, certain decision to face complex issues might arrive at the conflict vision, the author do something, but without a focus for discussion, they would agree without money points of clarity, potential to describe essential for follow-up, transition for work, problem, area, just open by focusing on the search to the problems of management, follow the day, accessory, and part of the difference in focus, country, to form the situation, the pride, better, depth of argumentation, facility, effective, just may be the right thing, and placing limits on the decision to face for arguments to be defined. If we really talk about topic, we or like the definition of justice but not possible. Argument the statement is debatable, yet it fails provide much basis for argumentation. The general subject is still too broad. This is not to say debate should avoid creative interpretations today. Over competing interpretations may be very engaged in debate, best facilitated by guys. My focus on a particular point of view B is vote negative one, preparation and class changing. The topic post facto manipulates balance of prep, which structurally favors the app because they speak last and reviewed every alternative. Strategic fairness is key to engaging a well prepared opponent. Topical fairness requirement are key to any meaningful dialogue. Monopolizing strategy prep makes discussion one side subvert any meaningful negative role. We're galloway and set the debate as a dialogue is set by the topical requirements. Or might have equity suffers to my person or one position. This is a fundamental condition of dialogue from male personal links. Fairness is a demand for respect. That month, our preparation not be sound. He's that then fairness excludes strategies one side comes meaningful participate. Make compensate for the world by offering a permit that maintains equality or seeing a conversation in case by defending the state action or generally you probably be permitted for presenting me a form of negative run value exchange or maintenance substitute for capital action not through dialogue. But in a second, is substantive constraints on the debate are key to actualize effective pluralism and agonistic democracy drives against like agonist or hostile sets of consensus leading to violence behind rationality. But neither one to abolish communication, name, or difference movement, especially in terms of engaging political justice, proceeds matters of open conversation and democratic identity. First, agonist and agonist are communicating democracy, which goes to people's respect and procedure rules of fair discussion, just to make neither proposed on regular pluralism and alternative consensus to regular. It should not be just procedural for that. It would apply anything goes in terms of substance agonistic ideals and demand judgment about what is worthy of respect and what is not. There's a specific consensus, but in retreating from all terms of the principle of regulating the consensus of what rightfully belongs on the debate, and constraints and deliberation are necessary to refound the political and untamed agon of eviscerates political action and judgment tills. Vila 96. For nature having different eyes, means the ability to relativize unity in a rent, the play of imagination energy, effective focusing your judgment, agent attention, each and perception is the effective place one beyond the community of interpretation or denying the background of consensus, robbing the political bomb, fundamental epistemology, weak condition, there be no arena, competition, why her place, interventional language, change to the kind of editor, such history, judgment, interpretation, assess that, the death, judgment will not, granting issues, guarantees that the article will not be conventional, common sense, close to the world, insofar as common law is tricky, so the serious sense can adjust themselves to not destructive in the world, cure, we don't say separate for appearance of productive, without abolishing the world, remove subjects from protecting them, be without recourse to objective grounds, validation, change under term, be no longer persistent, the ongoing process of change our runs account research to interest of nature of judgment while serving links between the public and universal capacity of judgment requires neither grant to no ground nor universal argument and rationality practical questions do not have the truth yet political judgment helps tame the agon by reintroducing the connection between plurality and deliberation debate not consensus conscience political life judgment we open space of deliberation and by necessity and action in such a way that contested or not the house judgment but a kind of regular ideal the evaluation of no difference but the isolated of the public welfare framework votes you're running without under the very specific purposes precisely public one constitution plurality which enable the most articulate expression of different government judgment point to the rules and like from the community of red letters, men and nerves serve not only denied possibly any overarching meta descriptive better diverse language I have rule games and conventional but do not possibly politics distant for space lenses since I possess and distant and distance interest behind the line of a false dichotomy between universal and distinction of fragmented both metaphysical realm in which discourse reflects the ability to create new interpretations within the way of common sense renders a commonwealth of fibrillar affirmations but an exaggeration of human tendencies or reality I run in asceticism and conversations to hope I meet the and action of public will itself, which is blurring obscurity makes increasingly difficult to articulate. This impact outweighs the deliberative debate model, impart vital skills to respond to existential threats. Lomberg intended the democratic capacity built by the debate of critical thinking and analysis of public place and forces of making, but the local government, global life, and our registry, and the new bureaucratic, and insular politics, policy, and social to give up liberty, industry's capacity to change, which is the reason there is high agreement that change debate bills, built that offer research about decisions to inform the new evaluate judgment for arguments in an increasingly environment, rich environment, and prior choice there. Well, political energy failing universities is not the day of change of curriculum, that's challenged to new information environments and that future institutionally. To make a value choice, but increasing confidence in private, not a top student being assigned the learning, study, substantiate facts, claim that debate plays a role in problem solving skills, the evidence, warrants strong support for debate as I hinted there again. The learning capacity, combination of critical thinking, processing, and capacity to software, open engagement, charges that debate is crucial component for democratic life and merit, creating for self control students, open to meaningful political engagement, new articulation, democratic life, more likely engage across the more likely we are to observe, reduce, provision to democratic life, necessary democracy to that democracy faces challenges, including class, gender, racial, justice, environmental, structure, climate, intervention, and conflict more than any specific proposal, century that delivers a racial threat, but so for existential challenges and guidelines. For dialogue are intersubjectively possible and are necessary to cultivate democratic habits and political judgment. The affirmative rejection of these types of constraints goes too far, high mark. Narrative pointing out the vision of subject marks that all language fast and line reads for the dangers possible by which these figures under the pretext of eliminating the reason centered around subject found themselves in metaphysical hyperbole. The identity they support, between knowledge of how leads them to place the human ideal beyond meaning and make it inaccessible in relation to which the identity individual can only renounce their autonomy. The thought fascinated by the absolute becomes a form of regression dispossessed. I do this subject on both the fact that the practical levels down and to make attention to which these research values is only investing in antiquity and unless questioning against the benefits of high value much for non messing humanism or world of the human reasons functionally provide a base for inner subjective changes constituting the best defense against power fascist character of our language for disorder function is presupposed by every subject change parts of this permission and ethical the principle of those wrong to claim fully practical social community. international agreement that activities must be treated no longer in terms of intercepting purity, but from the pragmatic view or efficacy is understood by basis of results in daily life and debate inevitably involves exclusions and more normative constraints, making sure that those exclusions occur along reciprocal lines is necessary to foster democratic capitalist return and solve the entire case. Henderson 6, embracing alternatives involved, would develop a newly exclusionary norms, but do more to gesture towards adopting and practices of various students forward-looking, policy of way-believing, anti-exclusionary politics, because, excuse me, it's a part of who we are, even in opposition to politics, our country, redestined policy, retreat, is necessity, but let's feel the change to our value, continue from power, and normalization, yet the decision does reappear on the knowledge and rhetoric of ability towards church, to generate political pluralism, the ability, once the church can appear non-normally bad, and universalism is not able to examine its own exclusion, it is a mere scarcity of communicated reason, and just my ongoing self-control process due to cultivation of practice enable democratic for patient typically of logic exclusion does not mean the activity is not normative. There is a slight of hand energy of these companies for normative steps to give a larger of practice that are made by the same value principle community as the rigorous scrutiny of discourse, but rely on democratic conversation community as to clarify where we might locate the preconditions for such activity by justifying its own value of substance by own supposit, not proper rather clarify all critiques of power community as to identify practices that foster democratic by casting all practices normalizing baller native disables or product and please no recourse for dogmatic condemnations.
Do you want this last card? Yeah, I'm sure.
Exclusion is also inevitable. Respect for democratic reciprocity and a fair even take of debate is necessary to stop arbitrary exclusions that stifle dialogue.
Actually, hold on. Yeah, we just said.
No, you said unblock. Okay. U.S. hegemony's vital to global stability. Brooks, Eikenberry, World War 13 engagement preventing dangerous global current environment. U.S. presence gives leverage to retain product. I have lots of interest in her. It's been producing a sense of creative justice that so seared lambs absent America, mere strong progress, dangerous, multiple reasons for cleaning security, competition, sharp, proliferation, and red war temptations. Once hegemony feels great around with Europe, as well as the Middle East, intense, fresh, great, dumb, Asia, like the friendly capacity, which was decent, was already defensive, real, and optimism, dependent on highly restrictive assumptions that same process is not right. The current report, which is sad to be able to show that deterioration is a survival yield, crisis, instability.
I'm going to mark it up. Mark that crisis.
Hold on, let me turn that up. Okay.
Quick question, is the hedge argument, is it a reason the AF is bad, or is it just a competing sort of vision of utopia?
Both. Okay, you affirm the utopia of hegemony, that's the advocacy you'll defend?
For now,
okay. Right.
If Bosu wants to go for shit,
I assume you'll say that this solves our science fiction arguments. How is affirming the utopia of hegemony any different than what happens, like, I don't know, every day of American sort of political think tank
discourse? Because the SWO is not nearly unipolar enough. Like, we should make it a little more hegemonic.
It just needs a little more hegemony, and that'll do the trick.
Totally.
Okay. Let's talk about framework. The interpretation.
I know. When you look at the world through that lens, it sounds pretty stupid, doesn't it? Like, just like a reason why you took it.
Yeah, that does sound pretty stupid, which I think is the argument we're making. Anyways, the interpretation. The affirmative should defend the desirability of a topical government action. Why do we not meet that interpretation?
We read T cards that you don't meet.
Okay. Well, let me ask one question about USAF equals DOD components. What is the how do we violate this?
Navy, military, and army as they exist in the SQUO. Your AF is not that.
Because
your AF is a non-existent thing.
Because it's the future.
Your AF
okay.
is a voluntary USAF.
The freely evidence indicates that debate requires a specific point of difference in order to promote effective exchange. What constitutes effective exchange in a debate context?
We would think a situation where the negative is, there's a reciprocal relation where the negative has some more.
When in debate is there ever a reciprocal relationship between what the effect?
Yeah,
and the
you're right. We're not gonna say that like our definition of reciprocity is like the platonic ideal of it, but that doesn't mean it's not a good normative idea.
Yeah. Okay. So, but like, what is a situation of ideal reciprocity, I guess, or good reciprocity?
Like when we have a specific case neg.
So the only debate that's fair is when you've got the case neg to debate.
No, it's not that. It's not just like fairness. It's just like those debates are better because both sides are more prepared.
Is there an independent sort of fairness component to the framework?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
What is the reason fairness is good? Is it this
because
sort of
debate is a game, and games are no fun if you mess up the rules.
The Dreiseck evidence says substantive constraints on debate are key. What are those substantive constraints, and which ones do we violate?
We'd probably say all of the constraints or things involved in the definitions we've read, and you probably violate a lot of those.
Okay, let's talk about the definitions, because we keep coming back to these. Resolved is legislative. How are we not resolved about a legislative action?
Because you would not defend a legislative action.
We are defending.
That's not true.
Action.
We said we would.
We're going to argue that your advantage is not intrinsic based on the plan. Like, yes, you read a plan.
You read a plan.
But that is not your advocacy.
Yeah.
That sounds like an extra topicality argument, that there are things that the plan is effective in doing, not a reason why the plan doesn't.
No,
Yes, but when you make the entire debate about the extra topical components, and that
it's
extra topical component happens to be utopia good, it's like. a little different.
Okay, should requires defending our federal actions. If we defend...
What's the last card that you read? You sent it.
It was just like personal.
I Brooks and Woolforth, and I did not read that like last Anderson card of the dot.
Oh, this card was a hit.
I'm up. Is everybody timing that?
Yeah.
I don't know when the changes.
Yeah.
That sounds reasonable.
Teamwork.
I'll accept the roundup. Gonna be the first argument, then the second argument. And we'll let Dan to name you.
We'll go to assert the naming hegemony by naming them for them.
Language is violence.
Japanese utopia dissolved any portion of the affirmative. They affirm utopia as it is happening now. That is happening now. That's our quote-unquote evidence. The unbridled exercise of militarism is precisely the creation of a liberal utopia. A liberal utopia of Japan, which means that they do not inject this sort of they do not inject this sort of denial of the system that, as the gift that destabilizes and disidentifies with the given system, which means that they don't have a piece of unique reason why they engage with the public, which is a crucial question, which we'll get to the framework on even if it's true that hegemony is true and the hegemony is correct in the abstract, which we will contest. It does not matter. If they have no way to actualize that outside of this debate round, they also don't have a link card to our argument. Our argument is not that we cannot never use military power ever. It's that we should be more careful about using military power. It's that we should have to accept the actual cost of U.S. hegemony, which means that if anything, we make U.S. hegemony more reflexive, more responsible, and less violent. U.S. power rejection only leads to imperialism. Only by questioning the role of the military can we solve global problems. Policymakers must take the initiative and rein in the military through logical contest. Going to deny the veneration of the military has led to aggressive U.S. civil military relations. Civilian leaders are showing disquieting complicity for all the dangers of militarization of U.S. foreign policy. Represents the most crucial threat to home front. America starts told that all sorts of trade-offs must be made surrounding the economy out of deep recession. None of these cost-benefit analyses are made with regard to the armed forces. There can be no compromise in a self-perpetuating cycle that continually renewed by its own questions. Subject to the limitless American power, the policy equivalent of shifting deck chairs on the Titanic. The greatest irony is that it leaves America actually ill-prepared for the future from global health pandemics and global economic instability to vast criminal networks, failing states, rise of semi-autoritarian governments. These aren't confronted by F-22 so long as the military is dominated by the national security agenda. The U.S. could continue to perceive the challenge of military terms. Policymakers must do a better job of addressing the real challenges. end the discussion by suggesting the country must a big military ensures that the American foreign policy will continue on the same dangerous path. Also, permutation of firm hegemony as dystopia. That's our more than necessary case. You have to inject a sort of dystopic view. This is what causes the reflexivity that we say is necessary in order to prevent violence. Also, there's no impact on hegemony probable in test causes of questionable logic of the demonic stability theory for the very beginning. Trade routes and may not be policed by a single law. The power of the international economy is a resilient supply to short all that could be temporary. Extremists are scared about how the comparable Soviet Union is frankly so that we mortified Bin Laden. Then we do this Stalin and Chairman Mao. Many factors have contributed to a dramatic decline in the number of wars on wheels. You expect that new conflict will erupt if the U.S. will draw down its military power and call other countries to play a larger role. Starting hegemony as a response to the evacuation of concrete political decisions by political and economic globalization. It's an endless string of enemy creation, permanent development across the globe, conversion of politics, policing you. Even if hegemony isn't clocking, it's only because the affirmative politics dooms America to winning the permanent war of attrition called the intent. The negatives. Though the U.S. is a solitary hyperpower, the heart of a hyper-economy and survived a dual conflict between superpowers is not the empire, and yet it is engaged in global war. The United States of America, a revision of politics more often adopted by defeated powers who want something that it has never been allowed to have in a concrete way, unilateralism, the ideological structure that whatever is good for the U.S. is good for the rest of the world, the U.S. but its most precious human values, American particularism becomes a un-American universalism, the U.S. is on balance to the victory over the Soviet Union. Without that enemy, the U.S. now feels alone, exposed to a force to confront the world's disorder, territorial energy, religious claims, intertwined globalization vortex to respond to the U.S. as it seeks to impose a hierarchical imperial order on the anarcho-plural disorder of the world and supplies an endless military apparatus to fight four large conventional wars at the same time, maintaining its defensive capabilities to protect from nuclear attack, deliver a devastating strategic response ready for China, rogue states, terror space, and more amazing than exercise of sovereignty in a classical sense. We can conclude that underneath the general jumble of global war, the steady concept of permanent geopolitical interests remain in place. In reality, this is not only improbable but also deceptive. A retrospective rationalization for situations does not follow a great strategy convicted itself in a series of blows struck all over the world in response to local crises. American military action seeks to be an operation of continued substitution of a world order that does not actually exist. Armed struggle against terrorism is a continuation of new politics of immediacy between economic rationality and violence. Even American empire is allowed to decline. It may be an empire of chaos, condemned to fight fear, ever but never reach peace or allow peace of God to construct the eternal order of some 84 deinstitutionalized countries. No international system exists. We see an asystemic global system, deterritorialized economics being changed by deterritorialized politics, which brings war along with it like its own shadow framework. We meet all of their interpretations except for maybe substantial, which is considerable importance of American heritage to 2K. However, no FBC definition of substantial if it's true not. That is a thesis argument which you should read through a framing argument. We have read a topical plan, affirmed it instrumentally. Policy debate is always already fiction, which solves all their offense means we meet all of their interpretations and avoids all of their exclusion argument, avoids all of the exclusion good arguments. Recognizing this constituent fact is necessary to activate political agency. They're doing science fiction too when they read a policy app. It doesn't have to be shitty science fiction, which is our argument. Mickey and Roman Alley and two very few debaters understand the decision-making process that elected officials employ, the inability to inevitably divorce the debates from the real world, just like in straight to Dallas Perkins commented, the judge is not, in fact, the policymaker. The appropriate resolutions are not typically a tool of policymaking. In the real world, policy discussions that a number of alternatives would be far greater. Policy options are brought before committees to be worked out between the House and the Senate. And the president may veto most debaters, never hold public audience. There are technocrats to spare in the boardrooms of corporate America. We need more social critics who are capable inspiring citizen actions. A better metaphor would preserve most of these advantages. The potential of literature to influence the political process is assumed. Lincoln once credited Uncle Tom's Cabin with starting the U.S. Civil War dystopian literature and emphasized the limitations of alternative worldviews. 1984 and Animal Farm are classic examples of utopian literature and historically important social function. Looking backward, inspired a political party. Feminist utopians included Herlin and are embraced by many feminist utopian literature. An important part of the history of American social movement, utopian science fiction will continue to play a role in future efforts to inspire social change within the power of debaters to perform the desired action. Debaters should understand themselves as budding social critics in the search for an optimal, practical, and cultural policies debate as social criticism is not reduced as restricted to a technocratic elite. As such, the criticism is necessary to prerequisite to any effort to create policy change, whether articulated by an elected official, a mother, six cop, and elders, or well known for their analytics, with formal agenda for policy change and from the public agenda, which is composed of all things that work outside formal policymaking circles, social movements, lobbyists, committees, mass media outlets, and appalls, all constitute the public agenda. The policymaking metaphor is given primacy to the formal agenda at the expense of the public agenda. Debate as social criticism does not entail the exclusion of formal agenda concerns from intercollegiate debate. The agent of action makes ignoring the formal agenda an impossibility. Students are working in their own modest way to shape the public agenda. Strictly speaking, debaters engage the creation of fictions and the comparison of fictions to one another. Debaters have used fiat to propose radical changes in social order. The wide range of policy alternatives suggests as a sign of a healthy public sphere. Utopian fiction makes it possible that the instantiation of inward core vision prerequisite to building the good place in the tiny corner of the universe. This is especially true in the context of our unique disarmament. They have conceded the thesis of our thesis level of our impact plan, which means that engaging social activism in order to stop this sort of hyper-militarized mass media calculations that are existing in the status quo is necessary to prevent extinction means to try or die for the affirmative. Also deals with their hegemony. The core distinction is one of predictive versus speculative fiat. Then it's our booth evidence. Science fiction builds a reflexive capacity instead of prediction. That's the only portable skill that outweighs of their arguments because debate is terrible at making actual predictions. It's also key to viewing public policy through the lens of science fiction, which is a unique and necessary means to facilitate social transformation, dialogue, deliberation, all the things they talk about when they talk about framework. Miller invented an 8.
The most important project may be to try to identify mechanisms through which science fiction could be meaningfully integrated into society's institutions for public engagement. Political culture is deeply oriented toward the present, especially with regard to framing its regulatory gaze. Your regulatory culture is founded on the axiom that only harm and actual image are generally subject to redress. Planning ways to be more future oriented would add substantial value. Judicious mixture of science fiction writing to sensibilities and scenario writing practices could substantially enhance the public engagement possibilities associated with scenarios. Methods have increased considerable power facilitating citizen buy-in to the assessment process, results in policy recommendations or scaped in scenarios and directions unexpected by expert participants. Likewise, a front runner to formal assessment process, writers might be able to develop multiple stories and dialogue. Science has become one of the most powerful forces of social transformation. We need to develop new tools that can help the public vitally engage vitally with scientific and technological future of our current increasingly caught up in not only physical transformation of matter, but the biological transformation of life. One such potential tool is the new social literary techniques built on the strength of science fiction. Prefer our substantive impacts over their fairness thing process for party in the way they perfect the technique and debate and give Alex Miles a good time. It doesn't matter if we win there, the framework is violent and necessary exclusionary prevents the possibilities for us becoming political debate. It's not just a game, but it's how we perform our political subjectivity, which means that this is necessary. No impact of fairness anyway. Disparities are inevitable. Systematically disproven and self-correcting. Reasonability. Voting out does eradicate positive debate clearly because we have a point of flash. We have done an example of the resolution. The only question is predictive versus speculative fiat, which I think we are controlling demonstrably. The role of the judge should be determined with me. We made a good contribution to the large body of debate. Aft choice. Burden of majority means the negative needs to actually answer our arguments. Anything else is regressively anti-educational. Extra topicality is stupid. The idea of fiat is also premised on the idea that simulation is an important aspect of the plan. That's the exact same thing as saying science fiction is an important aspect of the plan, which is exactly our argument. Everything is always already extra topical, which is the reason why it's not unique. Offense also gives them more ground, so it's probably good. They say limits. Their limits are bad. Only by opening up different modes of thought experiment can we resist technocracy. But Miller, Benedict, both long-term theory about technology ought to not limit itself to narrow technical terms and contrast efforts to grapple long-term societal implications. Change must stress at least the social as much as the technical. Humans create new ways of living in and with and through technology. The wide range of interpretation of society is going to become more reflexive in assessing and anticipating society. It seems to be crucial to identify novel strategies for seeing thinker longer term. Science fiction offers potentially significant value. We also can't do literally everything because the entire point of an affirmative is you have to find an idea, then you have to find a scholarship that supports it. That is especially true in this context. We have found a piece of evidence that says that we should affirm war powers. We should affirm restriction of war powers in the context of science fiction, which is a good enough functional limit. Also, none of their arguments link. It's all about how we need a substantive constraint. We do that. It's constraints on deliberation. We do that. I don't know.
Missed one.
Guidelines for dialogue. We do that. Exclusion. I mean, you have to be part of the topic.
Okay.
Boom! Lights out!
I can't read, so can we turn the lights back on?
New stat. Please turn the lights
back on. Yeah, it's right next to Reggie.
Behind me?
Yeah. Press the top button on that.
Yeah.
Yay! What's better, hegemony?
What's better than hegemony?
What is better hegemony?
Hegemony that does not engage in paranoid threat construction. Hegemony that does not sacrifice actual threat calculation to the sort of idea that the American military must always be strong, this utopia of hegemony that you've identified.
How do we determine what's paranoid and what's not?
What?
How do we determine what's paranoid and what is not?
Science fiction is a pretty good method to do that.
And what is that metric? Like, how would we use that in the context of paranoia?
What?
Like, how would we use science fiction in the context of paranoia to determine a threat, if a threat was paranoid or if it was not paranoid?
I mean, this is part of our Miller and Bennett argument. First is that hegemony and also larger public discourse about how to conduct democratic deliberation is too focused on the present. It's too focused on these so-called imminent threats to the expense of longer-term societal...
Give us an example of a paranoid imminent threat in the scope of hegemony and a non-paranoid threat in the world of the AF.
For example, the idea that Iran is about to attack us. Non-paranoid, global warming.
Okay. So, but our impact is obviously not about like warming. Okay.
That's our point.
You said you create more careful hegemony. Who determines more careful hegemony?
You know, it's something we come to a decision about through deliberative practices, not unlike what you are suggesting.
Okay. Social critic is a bunch of your cards on framework. How are you and Bowman social critics?
A bunch of our cards on framework. We are social critics. We perform social criticism in the 1AC.
Okay, and your argument is that's important for subjectivity?
That's important.
Like how we shape our political subjectivities. We should be rhetorical critics or
social critics. It is important to be a social critic, yes.
Why?
Why is it important to be a social critic? Because injustices happen, bad things happen. We should think about the ways in which we can help resolve those things.
What does social criticism do for those injustices?
I mean, I think our piece of evidence is pretty good. It's also just true that we have to think about actual issues rather than the sort of science, the shitty science fiction as I have described it in the 2AC.
Sure, what do we do? So once we think about those actual issues through social criticism, what do we do with that?
I mean, it is a case of deliberation. We should go out. We should, for example, engage our legislatures. This is a good thing. We agree.
Have you done any of that?
Yeah.
What have you played?
What did you do?
I mean, we've been reading this app just now.
Yeah, what? Are what?
Yeah,
yeah,
new app.
Have you engaged? Like, who's your legislator?
Who is my legislator? Ed Markey.
Have you talked to him?
No.
It's kind of hard. It's hard to talk to Ed Markey
because of the structure of the deliberation.
You said debate's not a game. Why do you read a new app?
I mean, debate. Just to say it's not only a game does not mean it does not have a strategic component.
Sure, why do you read it?
Because we wanted to beat you.
Okay. What's the intrinsic link between the plan and...
Well, hold on. I have one question. What's more important, beating us or political subjectivity?
I think, fortunately, in this situation, those things go together.
I don't think there's much of a trade-off.
No, answer that question.
What do you mean?
Like, obviously, the strategic component...
Why would we have to pick one of these?
I asked you before the debate. If you tell us the 1AC, I'll tell you the 1NC. That would have allowed, you know...
No.
And you said no. Why'd you say no to that?
Because we wanted to beat you.
Okay, so what's more important in having a substantive debate about how our political subjectivity should be constituted or beating us? Answer this question.
These two things are related. I think that beating you is one way of forming a political subjectivity we think is important. That doesn't mean that it's necessarily...
So the negative should have an equal opportunity to beat you.
Sure, I guess.
Okay, great.
Equal, I don't know what that means, but yeah, you should be able to beat us.
Can I just email it? Flash.
Fair enough.
It's a tip. Hey, Suo, can you explain the speculative fiat versus other fiat argument?
Argument is that the idea that we can only do like things in the status quo, like the fiat current structures of government, is a form of predictive fiat, which, first of all, is science fictional to begin with, but also a shitty form of present science
fiction. Speculative is better.
Yes,
okay.
That sort of scenario building
Thank
is better.
We're good. Yeah, just put it at the top. Or put it at the very bottom. That's fine. I haven't seen it. Yeah, you should just take that out there. Hey, did you read this clock card in the 1AC?
No.
Read that I sent it to AC or
no,
press or okay. No, I just have to reread the one I see. But it is going to be like a bomb.
I expect no less miles.
The greatest you got to see it all in the theater.
This 2NC better make the lights go out.
That's pretty funny.
Thanks.
I did this earlier in some of it, and someone was like, are you given the ins or something?
Yeah, the last bit, yeah. It's like, I can just give every speech.
Isn't that the dream, though?
It's really not the dream.
He can just do the cross-ups as I do speeches.
Yeah.
That's great.
Dude, they'll recreate the 9-minute cross-ups of Doom.
I just cut them off.
I'm just like done with pro.
If you spent that entire 2NC prep doing crossings.
Doing strong.
Yeah, you're for it? A little flex prep?
I kind of like the idea of being
yeah,
he Miles
is
against flex.
Yeah. All views in every bit.
Regardless
of
the
other
team.
I think
crossing
is my favorite
prep.
Absolutely. I'm just starts continuing as well.
It really
should do the thing he used to do where he's like, that question's off when I'm stepping.
I mean, I've just never done that this year.
Dude, what are you talking about? He did that in our debate in GSU.
Yeah, when he was like, what is the Enlightenment? And we were like, what?
Oh yeah, he did do that, because people were just not saying anything.
Yeah, well, he just went full Foucault on us.
Yeah,
started
I mean,
asking
the
deep questions.
Well,
like,
how do you get an answer?
But yeah,
well,
that's not justifiable for stopping in time.
Like, well, that's a kind of big question.
I could have a lot of books.
That is,
I'm
with you. I mean, I'm
yeah,
this
is the extra one. Yeah.
Boom. It's not even that it was non-rational.
One said that this would tell me who has what. I have an orange one.
Don't drink.
I'm not gonna. This looks strawberry.
Okay.
What else? Strawberry. Oh, I'm sorry. I think mine's is. And there's Red Bull here.
I would actually love some Red Bull if possible.
What's
strawberry?
There's
a CC right there.
Yeah, I think that's
which one?
This one? Closest
to me.
Yeah,
right there.
Yes.
This is,
yeah.
An enormous red bull.
Can we
it's
like
bigger
than my face.
Can we
give
this
moving? Stuff can
be
even
more prep.
Six.
So, alright.
No, I took six.
Oh, okay, 124.
124. Okay,
that's
4 seconds
of key. 125.
I mean, I have a minute, so it's like, what is that like proportionally?
115.
Okay, it's the, like, longevity page, I guess. This, oh, I know you're laughing.
That's
true.
So,
yeah. The TA.
Okay.
The DA.
Was that Arjun's fault? Can we blame that on Arjun?
No, that was me.
Is there any sort of overhead?
Yes.
Yes?
This is always on the
Okay. Everyone ready?
You're not ready for this.
They have conceded the one of the link evidence to OR. Even if they win, that they lead to a better form of hegemony. They conceded the link to the plan independently. The evidence indicates exact restrictions on the executive makes flexible disaster response impossible. Also makes the sustainable foundations for unipolarity impossible because that causes escalating restrictions. This is all conceded for the one of the no new to ACR1AR answers. We made this. I'm not going to read any more link evidence on this question because they explicitly conceded in the 2AC, which is the link argument we can win on a low and effective disaster response. Keep solving Sanctuary Miller 11. That's Warner Bruce for today. Nuclear armed authority powers, Russian, China, Iran, North Korea, Pakistan, second day, safe failure, anarchy, terror, terror, cartels, I'm gonna finish the one and see Russian Waffle World Wars part here. Brooks and Wolfworth. One should see how the military spending will possible fast. You should have an interview. I did pull the essay that the recent global unforeseen damage. I control the U.S. engagement for peace. The argument that U.S. security members are unnecessary for peace cannot be lost. You're the U.S. leadership competition in the world. The region running a house atmosphere. Now the line by line, they say utopia. This is the utopia that's having inside the code. There are evidence below that says that militarism results in a trade-off with healthcare and funding for things like the environment. That is the utopia. We will affirm a world of hegemony, which those things do not have to trade off with others. Independent link argument to their Libya intervention argument. Libya intervention was necessary to maintain the cohesion of NATO, which is independently necessary to maintain hegemony because it causes left-hand alliances. The one I see evidence is pretty explicit that we can win a link argument. This evidence, there are gray evidence, says that the inevitability of war is just an elaborate social construction. Our evidence indicates that this would result in a drawback of U.S. forces that is fundamentally linked to our realism argument. Our brussels fold for preference with one T, and so as the card I just finished funnily indicates, the world operates via offensive realism, and that means that the idea of war is fundamentally not a social construction. This is a direct impact turned to the one T, which they can no link out of their evidence indicates cultural imagination is necessary for peace. If we can't even imagine a peaceful world, how will we make more? Our argument is that imagining that peaceful world is bad because it encourages the United States to become more isolationist in order to attempt to create a global utopia, which inevitably results in transition wars and extinction of the Remoyan evidence indicates the disrupt hegemonic thought that probably involve disrupting hegemony. Here's our best link argument. They say that they destabilize the system by giving it the gift you can't receive. You have to contextualize it in the context of our link argument by thinking about that is a rising power that cannot be incorporated into the unipolar system, which is the gift that the system cannot receive, and that causes the system in its entirety to collapse. They say militarism is utopia of hegemony. I answer that argument above. And also, another link argument, their standard evidence on 1T indicates the plan that results in like a citizen's democracy that takes the hands out of the experts. That means that would cause isolationism proven by the isolationist trend by a lot of the United States public Tea Party. The Tea Party, etc. They say we cannot actualize hegemony outside of the debate. Remember this argument when they say they meet on tea. They said nothing leaves the debate, therefore our impact does not matter. That is why Arjun is going to explain this a little bit more on the tea debate, but this is always how these debates go down. They might read a plan and say they meet in terms of textual function, but the way the debates go down, they always say that there's nothing leaves outside the debate, etc. We don't get a link to our arguments in, and they say, oh yeah, also we're utopian imaginaries of hegemony, which means that we don't have to lead the debate, and there are evidence that indicates utopian imaginaries are good. We would just result in, you know, utopian imaginary of the citizenship be engaged in war, unipolarity. They say we will be more careful about military power, etc. In the setting in the world of the affirmative middle link arguments above, this is the utopia we solved because it's a world of militarism where the healthcare and the environment also there. Evidence indicates that the military is bad because it trades off of those things. Obviously, if you deprioritize military, it results in things like cuts that pull back our forward deployed presence. They cannot toe the middle line that they are trying to be saying by saying that they result in better hegemony because they cannot clearly isolate what things that hegemony isolates are paranoid threats versus what they are not, which means that ultimately they result in a full collapse. They say permutation to the view of permutation hedge is a dystopia. They shouldn't get a permutation. This is functionally a method debate. They shouldn't get a permutation. This is functionally a method debate. Also, our impact turns our argument is that hegemony is a utopia, not a dystopia. They say there's no impact to it, and the status quo is structurally improving. They can't win any of their impacts. Lombard tends to see for century dominance, pessimism, and overview of the state of the world rather than being that sort of contender on your narrative. We should have ever all the areas of human existence that are the topic on the side of the development needs to work on standing 100 years that you're in the quality of the day with a higher frame of participation, lower wage differential. The loss is virtual for high elevated gains worldwide and showed the largest improvements in 1990 low expectancy worldwide is 32 years compared to using time now. World picture was less clear. Hopkins and Thor have shown improvement. Global promise of the climate radically real shift. The embrace the world is getting much better. The status quo is structurally improving. Gas 2-4. The world is getting better. Let's look at the actual data, not emotional measure. Global practice metric are necessary. Many tools improving having children level and their less likely to die for age. Why global mortality really is plunging to the average of the world. They are really good at solving problems that are challenging the world. If we win that the world is structurally improving in the status quo, there's only a risk that their new form of utopia, there's a new form of science fiction can mess that up. And this is fundamentally, it's fundamentally an impact term because their evidence is it displaced the science fiction narrative of the status quo. That science fiction narrative is resulting in a decreasing structural bonds across the globe, which is the two guards I just read. Only impact in the one to see is the environment. There's no impact to that. Here we miss UK, the unlocked division, less corrupt, lower human distinction, problem, human safety, and ability to live around the ecosystem, which is the bar form, and disease, redundancy, and speaking loss without collapse. The impact of the individual single responsible to human out of action can solve these global problems. It's robust. It's in resilient. Major 9, the new research on Yale reinforced that ecosystem resilient to be after evolution, environmental degradation, damage, ecosystem, department, single lifetime research, look at data, peer review studies over the past 100 years, and you should evaluate util first, composite, 5 more elements, judgment, results, and attention, values, maybe we're safe, confident, action, it is more mobile to seek solution, advice, hard, other, fine, research, data, time, place, and look at the precise, with adversity, impact, will alternate, something, world, death, and the result of the healthy, emotional, question, not a fight, world, compass, the result of boy that could afford the pleasure of Boston, suffered originally, final sentence, of the hard, risk, and moral grounds. These cards are impact turned to their mechanism of utopianism, because our evidence indicates that absent considering the consequences that are likely to flow from proposals, data cannot actually change the world, Isaac Q, the unequal concern of moral concern, because political responsibility, purity, intention, not ensured that achievement, one intention, world, around moral, purity, form, and listening to adjusted policies, much better on the hip, concept, intention, data, fact of action, rather than it was most significant to have moral, absolutely, it inhibits judgment. They can't simply wish away the world, the international world works, even if they win their card to the bottom, one to see that the international arena is fundamentally constructed at some basic level of language or inner subjectivity, etc. They can't just wish it away because it's too sick. It means that there's only a mistake out to transition, works towards in 98, that anarchy is socially constructed, but it is not because we're anarchy is out there, some form is not accepted, the decision to conform to the perjury, evocation, reification, by Bruce, transformation, restore, this is phenomenon, and national, it is your objective, history, can be divided, but not mean the word out there, there's no true ground, then anything goes, most modern suspicion leaders unable to come up with a critical claim of the door to slot out the positive ideas, be distinguished between COVID, how can you human change, will be constrained, the social track of critical theory represent, they can be virtual alternative, ordinary, constrained, I, historical, by science, plasma, and the case, logically cut off from the above ground to a merit of different, and the different projects. They say there's no impact to hegemony. Hegemony is necessary to solve inevitable great power competition that escalates. Fatwise is also wrong because the US didn't cut back and then, or they didn't read Fatwise, but a large status gap is necessary to for the love and narrow capabilities out across the status competition, even on states, competition, the basic, their goal shows the security reasons that have a competition, body partners, revenues, just uniform, share, strategy, data, set, as public, the unipolarity helps explain levels of competition among major powers of the 1991 returnable to an over the increased social conflict. Will you ever maintain the competition on unipolarity? Evidence suggests that you present the challenges as a simple to multiply the world back to you, more clear, strategy, a danger, border, with more claims, primacy, the potential major power work to drop the backdrop of world politics. Broad empirical analysis demonstrates our argument hegemony is necessary to solve peace in the absence of war, warfare, a empirical study of the implication of competition, logically unlikely to conquer a great power, and the unipolarity in the empirical literature, the English struggle, projecting a full competition, probably leaving unipolarity, large number of studies support the ambiguous hierarchy because increased order of the 2000 years exhibit precisely behavioral properties and latitude theory, session to 1700, 1900, unipolarity, warfare, and the average of early, one of the terms of capability spread, where reducing clarity, hierarchy, increased status, and for less capacity, or even sufficient, convincingly, the status of driver, your behavior causes the escalation of great power, warfare, and the unipolarity, the raises pressure of great power to people are motivated relative to status, you can give a little bit of capability distribution, foster ambiguity.
Ooh, I have 2 minutes and I have no cards. Do you have for me to read also? What's the card in this file that's like War Down? No impact to fair compounds and removal 3. The four emerging facial do not think of yourself out of fear. If you're someone to action, it's impossible to say whether they're action. Or if you're ready to action, state of pump, the response is never to love and do not feel fear. Can you open it for me, Arjun? But this fear is not kind of a condition such as no research that people feel actually that are not immediate threat, capable of losing property, overrated threat of relevant values, not the kind of fear, least on restriction, least on liberty, especially on 11. Her tailments came after deliberation. And no, lash out, gray seven, in the hands of paranoid leader, friendship, be policy, be analyst, war, however, political system goes down to for a purpose to check the executive, be an operative, real, war, business, not a public, advocacy, system, policy, be making for the adoption, is ensure the total security is not that convincing, should be dismissed for what is debating, what will the pragmatic area in Shah, and Germany's causing a structural decline in warfare, and the central liberal norms have eradicated warfare and structural violence, every steel study proves the only scenario for complex a shock to the system, like the affirmative, by trying to incorporate the gift that it cannot accept or deny. We are living on this peaceful period, the popularity of the belief in popular, by the 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 culture that helping us eradicate more community. The season reason there be no the worst of the major African worship and major reasons that the other average turning war related as second less 1% of fatalities of the country community century reduced ones arising nuclear weapons that leave the group aggression of the humans are prepared to do a thousand year ancient global loss of resolving the future of culture factory to explain how to drop in a world on social democratic ethics, but governments and marches and rally for each other, narcissists of the low level of the nation, the economic community by third of all decreasing advanced shores, the illusion of research otherwise lead to social unrest, they all average life and have doubles of which make us a little less willing to raise our eyes and harbor is harbor psychology, make global expansion let increasingly dependent and independent towards other made world mean a major case one will live in disruptive unpredictable events. So far, the nations are positive that the world can be, if they continue, world peace may finally come best. Extinction, outweigh structural bonds, Boston 12, extinction, resource, really, out of risk, extinction, existential mitigation, dog, the bottom, more cardio, alleviation, depression, suffering, human life, like it, every other generation, out of portion, never community, extinction, committee, risk, meta, existential mitigation, murder, how utility, nothing else, social media, will get out of come disease in the future, humanity, sparkle, my liver, millions, your descent, my bonds, villains, total, to the villains, more time, more people, small reduction, the probability, realizing the normal schedule, then how the immense benefits of limiting poverty or career
regularity. Alright, let us.
I already signed that card.
Okay, cool.
Oh, you sent it?
Yeah.
Well, not all, unless I'm either.
I don't know what you. Wait, what highlighting did you
write? Blue and yellow.
Okay, let me reset the thoughts. If you read blue and yellow.
What was happening?
I didn't think he read blue and yellow. I'll send it again.
But it's just all the things that are highlighted, right?
Yeah, but I think the highlighting changed when I inserted an email instead of putting it in a doc.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's good. Get started in the interest of.
I was gonna say, Miles having a little more trouble with email than I expected.
Alright, it's on.
Okay, great. So, what does it mean to have a link to the plan in this instance?
We said that the federal government should not restrict the president's authority.
Yeah, but like the mobile infantry is armed with guns that shoot nukes, so why does it need.
Well, you didn't counterinterpret USAF in the 2AC, so if you're gonna say you meet, you conceded that you restricted the Navy, the Army, and the.
Yeah, we're tired, but the app happens in the future, so, like, what does this have to do?
Okay, we're impact-turning your method.
What
like,
that?
I made, like, a ton of link arcs to the
okay,
plan.
So it's to the sort of performance of science fiction.
Oh, are you saying that you're going to no link out of the link we read to the plan?
What link did you read to the plan?
We read a card in the 1 and C that restrictions on the
about
executive
restrictions
bad.
Now? That's temporally totally desynchronized with the plan, right?
We also read a card that should mean present tense. And you didn't counter-define that.
No, your card says should means obligatory.
No, it means present tense. No,
dude, okay, maybe you can read one of the one in R that says that. That's cool. Alright, so that's your argument for why you link. You read a card that says should.
Well, yeah, we read a link to the. You said in the cross-ex of the 1AC, if we win that the federal government should not restrict the president's
authority. And then I went on to say it matters when you do it, right?
No, you were like. I was like, what? And you were just like.
I'm sorry that you. I'm sorry that you didn't understand me. Okay, so this is what we're working with.
No, because you were just
that's reasonable. Okay. What restrictions? In what way does the restriction of the plan restrict the president's ability to respond to crises?
Well, it prevents our ability to respond to a future crisis, even if it's a
Why?
Future government.
But what is it? Like, what about these restrictions does that?
You restrict his ability to send armed forces into probable conflict
situations.
No,
he can still send armed forces. He can't send armed forces composed of the all-volunteer force.
All of our forces out there.
That's our argument for the draft. Okay. That's reasonable too. Okay, let's talk about the permutation. So you made it pretty clear that you know, affirm hegemony as utopia is an advocacy that you were, you know, going for. Did you go for it in the 2NC? Did you extend it?
I did.
Okay, and so why can't we permute that?
We're just saying you shouldn't get a permutation.
Why?
Because you haven't justified it.
Okay.
It's an app burden.
Okay.
We think this debate should be
okay,
about
so perm, you didn't justify it, so you don't get a perm. That's your only argument.
Well, we think the debate's about competing methods, which obviates the question of op cost.
Okay. Why is the rising power the gift to the system that the system, like, that destroys the system?
I don't know, that's just like a contextual link argument. What do you want me to do? Like,
so you read like a line from our evidence and then you
No,
that
like
China.
That was your explanation of the app and the 2AC. You're like, we're the gift that destabilizes the system. I'm interpreting that as the link argument.
Why they do not meet that 2MX1's educational testing resolution exists to ensure a balance of ground that's fair, at least in the sense that there are good arguments on both sides of the debate to be had. The fact that they had a better political starting point or something is not offense for them. It's a link. It proves that they all their offense derived from utopianism, which is not intrinsic to the plan, avoids all technical engagement, and teaches topic post hoc, which shoehorns the negative in saying the only role of utopia bad, which is indefensible. That means the ass arguments are presumptively false because they have not been adequately tested. The external impact of this is political judgment, and as he steals Lundberg and Seiberg to the deliberate model that forces the resolution of specific targeted questions, generating opportunity, cost assessment, argument, development, information processing, identifying strengths and weaknesses of position, and persuading the listening to people you don't agree with. That's key to a capable citizenry link towards all of their offense, because it's the only way they create a monologue where the negative is never able to clash, which is our dialogue argument, which is playing a little bit. Second is fairness is an impact in and of itself. Debate's a game of inches, which necessitates that anything that gives them an unfair advantage should be a reason they lose. You wouldn't let a marathon runner have a 2-minute head start, even if it takes hours to run one, because 2 minutes is way more than to gain enough a margin of victory. A game in which it's easier for one side to win is a reason to vote negative. Both sides are clearly going after the ballot. Any other claim means the app is arguing in bad faith, proven by the cross-examination, is also fundamentally denies respect for the negative by skirting engagement, which turns exclusion. That's the galley. That was your offense. because things like science fiction, etc. would be nice to have, maybe, but our argument is the argument about what the debate patients will think and what it should be in the context of the resolution. We meet debate. They do not want no link. Argument on the DA proves that they do not leave any room for defending action outside of the future, which makes it impossibly negative, which also means they do not meet the USFG. Their speculative and predictive fiat argument proves this, because they only affirm a speculative version of the USFG far off in the future, which is not the current government situation in DC. That their Erickson card makes any negative engagement impossible, since the app is all about future speculation and hope, which nobody writes negative arguments about, proven by the 2NC cross, like Rusuo nicely was like, there's absolutely no link. Second is resolved. They don't defend adoption of the plan by the current legislature, proves they are not firm or determined, since third should meet instrumental obligation and implementation, not their shifty bullshit, which proves that they don't meet either. They'll be explained below. I'm going to give you this card in a second. Should also requires me to see summer 94. The question is whether the question should be a surprising consensus means at the present time, as opposed to something that will become effective in a future practical legal threshold of inclusion of the judge intended is really as in the present resolution and substantial means in full existence and effect. This means that the plan's increase in restrictions must be tangible. The app obviously does not meet this. They literally don't talk about voluntary USAF may change, which makes it impossible to get links, but they don't meet their interpretation since they aren't considerable either, which means that new card they read doesn't matter. The McGee argument policy debate may be fiction in some regards, but that's not a reason for Bosu to be able to say Utopia Good with a totally unrelated plan and claim that they somehow meet the resolution. We are not all social critics. Debate does not shape our political subjectivities. We're only here for 3 days. All of us want to win. Plus, Suo works at Two Sigma Investments, which proves he is the corporate boardroom individual that McGee is criticizing. He has no way, they have no way to actualize the change that the rhetorical critic actually needs to do. Process in the context of the militarism argument comes before substance, which means that all of their arguments about the keys at Wang, etc., cannot matter. This debate should not have happened in the first place. There's needs weighing the cases of non-starter. We also have massive defense and impact errors in the 2NC, which we can extend if we go for this argument later. The predictive fiat argument. We don't mandate solely predictive fiat. You can maybe use speculative practices to justify your fiat of the squo, which solves their argument. Debate is not bad production now. It's good for being able to have an effective dialogue, which is all of the impact. I explained about the Miller card. Science fiction might be good, but it's irrelevant if we win. It was unpredictable, which is all explained about the reasonability tangential relation to it. Tangential relationship to the topic is the worst of all worlds, because it allows the app of self-serving benefits of picking parts of the topic that bolster their ground while saying that there's no negative ground. They're only ever tangentially related in ways that it give the negative concessionary grounds, i.e. we can only say utopia bad. There, that's a moral hazard for the app to pick moral truism like arguments like murder bad, etc., and avoid hard mechanism questions which make you have to hold the line. It feels artificial political training is stupid instead of a model where we pick and choose where we want to defend while just wishing away relevant objectives, because we don't want to be as relevant for anything to ask. Always a step ahead of the negative in this world. It makes us accountable not only for preparing a negative to everything in the topic, we also prepare a negative for everything that could be related to the topic. This is a bad, this also takes out reasonability, because they cannot win. It's arbitrary, and we can never know which apps are tangential enough for some judges, etc., which proves that being in the direction of the topic is just as bad as not being topical at all. Why couldn't the app read about our word about restriction and then...
You know,
competing interpretations obviously therefore is the only way to evaluate, objectively decide these debates and stop random judge interventions all magnified by vague arguments. Independently new ass and this debate are uniquely bad because they didn't want engagement and actual change of subjectivity, which was proven in the cross-examination. And
do you want this card?
Yeah.
Clash and in-depth deliberation create more effective decision-making and absolute skills. Galloway and 7, specifically that debaters spend a firm decide and courage to admit falsely value using the absolute negative response to animal consequences than it was when the first plan is not possible without debate debaters fall prey to the control ideals or actually lost the number. A way to counter words deeper or understand master word counter words should be enraged by pronouns of critical or exposition because analytical and teaching law for enforcement and critical organizations of law for anthony's conclusions. Clash creates decisions that are better for having subject to the trial fire the commanded format and make point of view to which one is not a way to create an exchange of fear takes to experience short trigger their change. The framework violence argument doesn't make any sense. Anderson Carden, the one I see, is fantastic. You're responding to this, says it's not policing. It is a call for some type of provisional reciprocity, which they obviously obviate. Yeah, there is an impact of fairness. Debate is the game. That was all explained above. The limits don't have to be absolute. They are contingent in our framework. Teaches debaters how to speak in the language of experts. That's the best. Pop 99 policy makers should be able to mobilize available knowledge to crisis. There's no policy cards. How we evolve is made precise knowledge of policy. He should be able to mediate different disciplines. We should be able to mediate science, politics, social science, and multiple methods to enumerate policy relevant knowledge. Authority is linking inherent groups and experts in marketplace to ideas. It's private.
A quick market thrive.
How much time do we have? Also need that for
8:49.
I also get the interface shit.
Yeah.
Don't worry, you just send them both.
Yeah.
Do you highlight it differently?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Did you send me the stuff?
Yep, I just put it in. I'm gonna put it in the same. It's all gonna be in one doc.
Okay.
Like the whole one.
Okay.
Okay. Should have just sent you so. It has the hot card at the bottom, and you should see show it requires immediacy in the middle ish. Tell me if it's not there. Okay.
We're not done.
There's no two.
And then, sorry.
And the slam hereby is referencing a present tense. It says should is modified in its context by and the slam hereby is, which means that this is not.
I use 244 again.
609 left. Sunrise.
Close. I did 605.
Right cards like in one speech doc already. Just for
no,
the
I haven't read really one.
Gotcha. Kill those sweetlings.
Yeah, I was gonna say you have to pull out those sentences.
This is gonna take Brad like a minute and a half to read.
This time.
Yeah, that's right. And what else do you need?
Really, nothing. I'm not gonna reinvent the IR wheel on this one.
Oh god, what the You know that part of the Bird Suit article that talks about why scenario planning is good? Oh, that was slayed in this meeting. But I don't have a cut.
Oh, I do, but I can't read in response to this because.
No, that's
not
epic.
I know.
That's why I'm saying I want it.
Oh, no. That's why I'm saying I'm pissed I can't read it at all.
Yeah, you're just going to have to be like, I guess we can make predictions sometimes. It's because we know that China won't be in the world. Because, right?
Oh, dude,
right?
What is that called again?
I don't know. Like Chandler or something?
No.
It's like the car. So tight and red gun. Oh, that's a terrible argument.
You're so confused.
Yes, trivial predictions are trivially true.
Okay, so the order will be the counterplan disadvantage and then framework slash probability.
Okay, everyone looks ready.
What are they?
Impact to the 1AC's hyper-militarist expansion space weaponization has created systems fundamentally out of control. Rational political actors that lack responsibility means accidents and intentional bringing upon of catastrophic nuclear violence becomes likely to fuel military machines that are out of control. The Empire and speed of light is fundamentally distinct from the current system of American dominance. Our point is that American hegemony's gone past any reasonable limits or streets of bringing on its own self-annihilation. That's an impact that is it's an impact they do not have any defense to, which means we are controlling a large-scale impact that outweighs any theory of permutation. Imagine hegemony is dystopia. Think about this. Our medicine system that imagining our two theories simultaneously creates its own cognitive possibilities considered strange as us from being forced into one vision of the future. What about a world with hegemony without a volunteer army? What about hegemony without endless military? Those become questions that the judge engages only through the combination will advocate the permutation whether or not they go for the counterplan. The usefulness of science fiction thinking means we can engage alternate possibilities within the project for the affirmative dust. Efforts and trends are good. Science fiction means conflicting possibilities even more politically activated. Species booth that is permutations are good. We've got a plan text, which means it's not simply about competing methodology, but competing most of legislative politics into the future is the argument that you usually make. Now, there's no link. They're going to forget that some of the point. He goes for framing the 2NR, but it doesn't link because it doesn't make any sense. For the mobile infantry who uses mobile nuclear weapons shooters to link their arguments about hegemony right now are is speculation to the future, which means hegemony good now is irresponsive. They're not a cognitive strength of the utopia happening right now. Brutal exercise of militarism is the creation of a liberal utopia of hegemony. They do not inject denial of the system as a gift that doesn't disidentify. We should imagine the collapse of the system through a brand new rising power. It doesn't mean we should imagine that. It doesn't mean literally let it happen, but it's probably useful to imagine a peaceful and violent rise anyways. They also literalize the erasure of the body of soldiers that are one as he criticizes hegemony is good in the abstract, but they don't ever talk about the sacrifice of soldiers, which are in case leads to the worst forms of militarism. Now, even if it's true that hegemony is true in the abstract, there's no way to actualize that outside this debate right now. We can't use military power ever. Be careful about the military power. We have to accept the cost of violence. Our argument is that nothing goes outside this debate. Our point is that they don't get outside this debate because they are not a useful mode of engaging science fiction or dealing with the deliberation that exists. We do have that. Brinken and Moylan evidence indicates that we have created a counter-public through the reading of the 1AC, which rendered the 1AC possible in the first place, which was the useful political act which allows us to take new possibilities outwards. We resolve the difficulties of hegemony, which means we resolve the dissent and counterpoint even without them. Cohen, not evidence that's criticizing military overstretch itself. He concedes it's what the utopia looks like. Militarization causes overstretch, which kills the economy, cost benefit analysis, slanted, or pro-military causes unsustainable nation, laundry list of large scale, small scale violence. The world is getting better, doesn't resolve our impact. It's an example of spiraling out of control, not whether or not the growth rates are happening. People have more money, which means that's fundamentally not responsive. Libya is doing so hot right now after the American intervention. Now, we're not wishing away the system. Our point is that we're a form of movement against hegemony, but the booth and the Moylan evidence are reason why it's important to affirm the temporary time jumps with all their impacts are wrong, Bernstein and L2K. Scholars separated policy theory and has decided to quality their work with five decades produced led little in ways useful results payment at the rate most relaxed scientific testability. It's impossible to sign metrics rate to various polarity relative power melts power. The no commonly accepted by the definition almost every evidence statement watching much likely be tested to compromise rage over the definition of deterrence and bound regarding governments and theories of bedline idealization cops rational to balance power not a reality, but theories that do not exist in never interpreted judgments interpretation leads to widely very future proper definition that resolve we would still find impossible to construct large samples enough to permit statistical analysis various across time complexity like the general theory of extraordinarily low just one friends requires the dividends cases and it's impossible molecules do not learn from experience. People do neither appease nor tries to be explained without understanding the concept which they are formulated, market formulated hegemony is wrong and balanced piece of Gali Evans globalization back away traditional spatial categories which relied upon defined hegemonic reach nation state boundaries are disturbed by global capital and immigration security is disturbed by terrorist incursion mass citizen movement and immigrant in connection asserting hegemony in response to attempts to reimpose those spatial categories which create an empire of chaos which may continue to win the wars but it links to an infinite balance which causes more war and hegemony doesn't even exist till 13. Let's skip that card. I don't have time for that framework. Debate is a fiction. None of their offense links to us, and they independently link to every one of their disadvantages. They concede a uniqueness of the debate. Communities torn apart by the sexual technicist, policy guy oriented, political science oriented evidence found in affirmation of the U.S. federal government endorsing a pedagogy that is fundamentally exclusive with other modes of engaging the topic. Affirmative is part of a broader assemblage of teams acknowledging that simultaneous valuability of multiple kinds of engagement while not explicitly enforcing an ideal for what constitutes good debating. It's try or die for us, even if they win their impacts, their deliberation skills they won. One at the exclusion of participation creates a fundamentally unstable model for the community itself and the role of judge. Whether we made a contribution to the larger body of debate, we do defend the topic of plan, which means we both the question of having good political starting points. Centered on text and on their arguments that some kind of exclusion are useful. Now they see ground, but utopia bad is an enormous literature base, so it's not just science fiction. Good that we also read this argument 2 years ago when they were both debating, which means they probably have a backfile on this. The idea that utopia is good is the only argument they can read represents their failure of the imagination rather than our treating the vibrant discussion of the feminist race studies about the role of futurity, plenty of discussion in relationship to Marxism means there's plenty of literature based. In fact, they haven't done any of that research, they don't think it's important. Now the limits argument, their limits are bad. They can see the middle piece of Miller and Benedict indicates that they use a set of pre-selected technocratic limits, which understanding, which makes it impossible for us to understand long-term social implication means you can't even be because they pick the slightest choice ability for deliberation and react to any sort of new situation only holds us to, you should also only hold us the passive voice part of the topic that one the voter originally but then grasped the votes were controlled by a policy-centric set of schools to push the war power through, which means that their reading is fundamentally anti-difference. That also doesn't make any sense. Voting affirmative gives us 2 men ahead start because it presumes that there was ever a 50-50 relationship in the past that's structurally untrue, which our point which our affirmative is pointing out. There's no link argument was no link argument was explained above in the disadvantage use. So we said if you negated the affirmative we'd give you a link. You just read bad arguments. We do be United States voter government. We are affirming the United States voter government that exists in the future, but they can see that the USFG itself is fundamentally speculative politics also already science fiction.
fiction avoids all their exclusions. The armies, they're doing science. They are doing science fiction anyways. It can be useful as McGee and Romanelli evidence to a red. The judge of the policymakers, fundamental fiction using metaphors and new ways of mobilizing social activism in ways not defined by technocratic spheres. The only way to actually activate a largely deactivated sphere of political agency. Now, children and kids, if you treat this new Oxford American Dictionary justified because of any new explanation of what you mean coming out of one hour was too late for explanation anyways. Their own evidence is talking about a situation where should is modified by the phrase in the present context, which means it doesn't determine the resolution, which doesn't include that phrase. We meet every one of their other interpretations substantial is of considerable importance to the American heritage. It's American heritage. If they win their substantial definition, nothing meets, because nothing's ever as substantial. If they talk about in the utopia, good element of the affirmative, exactly the same thing. When these guys are Georgetown read a policy affirmative, then say simulation good, that's the exact same type of thing. It's not unfair, it's not extra top, it's not something we're uniquely doing. It's structurally the same type of situation where you claim advantage of the way that you are advocating this particular mode of pedagogy, which is precisely what we are doing now. Effective dialogue still possible, morally affirming. There are tons of possible ways to engage, which was about the tangential relationship argument. We're not tangentially related to the topic. We're central questions topic, which should structure the U.S. What the structure of U.S. armed forces look like, whether or not Libya was justified, is also central element. Those are all but we have a central question of competing interpretation. The moral hazard gets raised to the bottom. This is the moral hazard. We make an effort to meet them in the middle, and they still say we aren't good enough. They see new officer bad, but they're good. One, they make being into fixed identity, but being is becoming. That's a balanced circumscription of identity, which is impacted. But two is that it really relies on a false dichotomy. If it can be both a game and an activity with meant social and strategic calculation, like new affirmative key to reinject it with not winning finals. It's particularly important because people actually care and listen.
It's like, I don't know, it's kind of a nice challenge. I don't know.
Well, I guess it's the executive MT. The executive DA, like Hedge MT. Whatever.
Not a lot of names. Signify.
Classic. Okay, we're good. The counterclaim not can be over kicking the counterclaim means they can't advocate the permutation. There's no logical reason for this, since it's no longer an opportunity cost. The affirmative also topicality has to confirm this. Presume that when the substantive impacts of the 1AC matter or impact is about how the process of debate goes down and fairness has to confirm. That'll be explained a little bit more below. Now, the bottom of the day, when they say it's not about that, it doesn't go outside the round. It's only a question of whether you have a productive method that goes outside the round. That is entirely our point. When the affirmative gets a claim, extra-topical claims that have nothing to do with the extra-topical portion of the affirmative through which you view the affirmative or read their method, obviously they will always be on a step ahead on what is the more productive method that will leave the room that fundamentally makes an offense impossible, because even though they read a plan, they never defend it in a way that actually gives a negative any ground, anything other than concessionary ground, i.e. utopia, bad, which I'm going to do that a little more on framework, which I'll go to now.
Two impact arguments at the top of that were conceded makes it impossible for them to win this debate. First is fairness. The debate is fundamentally game. It doesn't craft our public political subjectivities. We're only here for 3 days. Suo is using a Two Sigma investments pen. He could not name one goddamn thing he did to solve his legislator. All of this means that the affirmative is arguing bad faith if they say that the debate is anything but a game. This means that you have to make it equal for both sides. We don't have to win that the Platonic definition of what equality is necessarily. We just have to win that it's a relative thing that you can define based on whether there's an equal clash of grounds. And based on what happened in this debate, there has not been and potential recess to be voting issue. Something's not contested coming out of the 1NR. It's not about what you do, it's what you justify. It causes an infinite number of affirmatives. Seriously, think about it. A future affirmative is exploding limits. Which government is it? It could literally be at any point in time. You could be deciding affirmative after the world in 2020 as we know it. Bosu still lives in their parents' basement and wants a utopian strategy to overthrow the government. The world as we know it in 2040, the government has been overthrown by Bosu's revolution, but the app wants a counter-revolution. The list is literally endless because the time interval is infinitely receding. This makes it impossible to be negative. It makes it impossible to be negative. Then you have bad argument. Then you have bad argument. The being become good argument is obviously stupid. We just have to win that a contingent limits is good. Our view live indicates that doesn't necessarily deny being in the face of becoming rather less more effective engagement within that. So you think about it like this. You have to create a small box in order for 2 points to be able to clash and effectively intersect, which is the one CP11 indicates means that accepting some limits is necessary to allow for more effective engagement. Terms are being argument. Also, this was obviously read for strategic purpose. I asked them to disclose it before the debate, and they refused to do so. If it's really about crafting political subjectivity, they would have done that. We could have had a better debate about the substance of the affirmative. Maybe I could have looked up that back file from 2 years ago, but instead they chose to break a new affirmative, makes being negative fundamentally possible. Independent reason to vote negative. Independent reason to vote negative improves all the arguments about how debate constitutes subjectivity are bullshit, and they're solely here to win. Second, the HOP evidence was conceded. Our 1NR evidence indicates you have to learn how to lead and speak the language of experts and switch sides on a topic in order to be effectively able to defeat them. Think about it like this. The affirmative has no way to mechanize Fox News. They just create the Stoner TV network, which fundamentally cannot get Fox News off of the air. Just creates an antagonistic political sphere, which ultimately no political resolution or questions are possible. If we win internally to fairness, it means that none of their substance is relevant because the debate should not have happened forward. I know I only said there's two things, but there's four. Our impact is about the process of debate. Our Scheinberg and Galloway evidence indicates that a clash process of debate in which there's a relatively equal preparation on both sides allows for in-depth decision making. There needs to be a specific point of resolution when the affirmative claims extra topical. It's not even extra topical. Just like they've asserted an arbitrary way to view the 1AC, which has no link, intrinsic link to the plan. Utopianism has nothing to do with the plan. It's about the imagination of the plan. We read simulation good cards against y'all when you say that the plan doesn't matter and you insert prior questions. Our argument is that you let the app assert those random prior questions that jack all relevant neg ground, proven by the fact that they said we're no link to the military DA because we are some goddamn future government. Now, the line by line, they say debate is a fiction. This presumes that the substantive content of the debate, is relevant. I went for bomb China against MSU. I obviously don't think that's necessarily a good idea, which proves that debate doesn't necessarily impact our political subjectivity. Also, this is bullshit. We don't go for framework against teams who actually believe in their arguments, but most who are just shysters who are here solely to win the debate. Now, they say deliberation is an evil exclusion. Our evidence indicates that exclusion is an evil saying that we can't run framework is just as exclusionary as excluding negative ground. Or once the understanding indicates that means you have to make sure the exclusion occurs along reciprocal lines. That is the only way to create a democratic ethos of respect and engagement, which is fundamentally a better way to solve all of their impacts, which is also a meta-level uniqueness argument that exclusion double they exclude the negative, proven by the new abstract argument. But they say they have a topical plan. I think I handle this efficiently over you. Arjun's tangential rant in the 1 hour was pretty fantastic. It was mostly conceded, allowing something tangential relation to the topic allows a dare to ask about democracy to come, because you don't need to read a plan, but then read a framing argument about that. They could read a delusion contrary war power, war machines app, and make similar framing arguments to the one I see that obviate all negative offensive list is potentially endless, proven by the fact that they always do this. They read apps that are tangentially related, but jack neg ground. They say utopia bad is a strategy. Their answer to you have neg ground is look up a back file from 2 years ago. If that sounds like a well prepared debate in which both sides have fair research and can clash each other, then maybe you can vote affirmative. But it's not, and that means they should disclose. They say it's a failure of imagination. I haven't even seen the movie Starship Troopers, which how am I supposed to respond to it?
I know.
They say pre-selected limits destroy deliberation. There is no alternative to pre-selective limits. The affirmative limits us out, which is the argument I'm making above. Our Anderson evidence is quite fantastic on that question, and we just have to win. The limits are contingently good, which is the villain evidence I was explaining. Above the internally skills of the impact of skills of omnis extinction or Lubberg evidence indicates that. It allows for a better form of advocacy skills in which we can engage with those who we disagree and persuade actual people in power. The affirmative is no way to get off the ground. Our methodology is a better way to do this. They say they're a passive part of the topic. That allows for an app to pick the moral truisms of the topic, like OU Zap, that simply says targeted killings are bad because murder is bad. That only gives a negative concessionary ground, but at the end of the day, that is always too convenient for the affirmative, but not super convenient for us. They say there's not a 50-50 relationship.
Oh yeah, they say the USFG. They say the USFG is a spectacle. Or should evidence that says indicates has to be in the present tense. Even if you don't think that's exactly what the evidence says, the fact that we have a definition defining it, they don't have a counter definition of should, means that you have to err affirmative the question, and their interpretation of should is not mutually exclusive. Meaning the permutation is able to solve. I didn't realize you had the limits. The permutation is able to solve the limits of facts. And they say simulation is good. That was answered in the overview. Is there anything else?
They're not tangentially related in USAF stuff. Because like we have a definition of USAF.
Yeah, USAF is the current arm.
I sent it error, like, should USFG and USAF.
Thank you.
All you that can see determines the way you interpret the rest of the framework debate. All debate is science fiction, but policy debate is shitty science fiction. This is something that they fundamentally conceded, highlighted throughout the 2AC. I've read a shit long card about the 1AR. Is the first argument, the 1AR, the USFG doesn't actually exist as we conceive of it. To debate the process of fiat is inherently science fictional and speculative. The only question is whether we mobilize the way we mobilize that in particular ways to implication forces it non-uniques all of their offense. Think about what would have happened if this debate were a policy debate. They read a DA that fundamentally didn't link it and was stupid anyway. We said it didn't link it. We crucially did not say that we don't defend the imaginary implementation and simulation of the policy action. They we said intrinsic dis was good. They said intrinsic dis was bad. We had a debate about it. They made an argument about the status of framework and the way that the 1AC is mobilized. Obviously, we say that things like simulation is good and science fiction is good in defense of our method of engaging with debate, which is exactly the same argument he makes when we read a critique, and he does the same thing, which sort of demonstrates that all of their framework arguments don't really make any sense. That this argument is just a will to limitation that is tearing the debate community apart. Second is a unique reason to prefer our method of debate. Literary imaginaries are a core way to engage. Question of social criticism makes a bunch of stupid ad homs. The fact that I spend my summer giving money to tech startups to demonstrate that SF arguments about deliberation over technological futures, not the other way around anyway. This is the sort of tangential relation question that is fundamentally bad. Debate is dying because of a strategy of negative teams and a broader way of thinking that focuses on a sort of predictability and limitation and excluding non-normative modes of advocating the resolution related to USFG. This bad faith argument goes the opposite way. This AF was for miles just because he pooped himself, didn't read any good arguments, does not mean that we weren't good enough. Now he says that we have to disclose our AF to him before the debate, and now he says that we have to do particular modes of this argument. Is that there is no unending argument. It's a race to the bottom. That is the core of our reasonability argument, which is an impact turn to all of their framework arguments because it destroys the possibility for respect and deliberation, which is the core internal link to every impact that they are going for. They can see the one argument that the passive voice should be the interpreter. Actually, I'm not going for that. They said. They said fairness is first. They don't have a reason for this besides this weird argument about how you shouldn't give people tipping something in a marathon. This is not a marathon. The entire argument is that we are structurally unequal at all times. It's not a 50-50 thing that you can tip one way or the other. It's a question of constantly negotiated arguments. The fact that we want to beat them does not mean that debate has no political content or political subjectivity. The idea that these two are fundamentally at odds is the same exact kind of hostage shaking that we're that we are critiquing throughout this entire debate are we agree with their framework arts that say that the sort of competition, the game of debate, is politically productive. The idea that I want to beat someone makes me make better arguments, makes me make more complete and logical and persuasive and powerful arguments. I think this is a particular reason why the desire for competition means that it enhances political subjectivity, not the other way around. They say it's not what you do, it's what you justify. They haven't explained why we justify all this shitty stuff. They conceded the fundamental question of the literature checks argument, which is that you first have to have an idea and then a body of scholarship that supports it. If we read the 2020 post-UF, they would just say that nobody actually thinks it's a good idea, because also I don't want to live in my parents' basement. They say UFs and contingent limits are good. They think on your feet evidence. They have conceded the think on your feet evidence. That's our Miller and Benedict argument. They're being faced with unpredictable futures and scenario planning is necessary, which is the reason why they should have been faced with this with sort of contingent unpredictability. And once again, it's not an independent reason to vote. Negative. If we win all the other arguments about how we control the internally to actual engagement with debate, they have no reason why policymakers can actually spill up to things that we care about. That is our core argument. If we don't do things like science fiction, differential ways of relating to the resolution debate can never become political, which means we control the access to the terminal impact. The evidence doesn't make any sense. We are the ones that teach us to communicate with experts, not speak in their language, but deliberate with them. That is our Bennett Miller evidence. Any other way of relating to expertise is necessarily disempowering and disenfranchising, which I think is the core argument that they keep conceding. There's Steinberg and Freely evidence. Once again, we meet the conditions for the success that we have to have a negotiated topic. I think this is pretty true of every card they are going for. We meet the negotiated topic argument. The fact that he keeps moving the barrier does not mean that it's pretty good. They said this year we're conceding particular points of ground to them. No, they just didn't read something that links. It's utopia bad. It's not their only argument. They could have said that the thing we did was bad. It's the thing that we did was bad, or that our story was bad, or any of these political things. The fact that they don't even think that the sort of Marxist literature on utopia or the Lacanian literature on utopia is important at all is proof of our argument, not theirs, because they don't believe that those things have political possibilities. Oh, they say we exclude them. No, they're just bad at debate. Well, no, that's not even true, really, but they didn't have a good answer to our argument. Go to the interpretations debate. I think that this is a structural question. If they're right about competing interpretations, there is no way of determining the question of extra topicality or whether we did any of these other things without asking the question of the topic, asking the question of what the words in the topic mean. We agree that you should be an example of the resolution. We're just saying that the relationality is different to that. He has no interpretation that he's extending coherently in the 200, which is about our ability to actually affirm a topic. Now, USFG in the present, not what their card says. That's our argument. He has to impute certain things in order to limit out more people. Should indicate immediacy. It's out of context, conceded argument. It's about holding in the present of, or something like that. That is a sort of legal context in which we deploy. Should means futurity. I should do something means I will do it in the future. This is our argument. This argument is fundamentally way more logical than theirs, which means it's not arbitrary and therefore more predictable. USAF, I don't even really know how we violate this. It's a spin-off thought at the bottom of the 2NR, no actual argument. If competing interpretations is not true, then you have to default to reasonability. The idea that they keep moving the yardstick for what it means to engage productively in a debate, what it means to be fair, is demonstrative that it will never be good enough. It turns their moral hazard argument. They have a moral hazard. They have an incentive to not prepare and then say they couldn't have prepared, which is the core of our argument.
It's not tangentially related.
Yeah, they made a bunch of tangential relation arguments. Our lit check arguments obviously answer this. Plus, we defended implementation. It's not a tangential argument. Also, that begs the question of what any of the interpretations mean. We meet all of them, and the one that we don't meet is really stupid. They didn't extend substantial.
Yeah. Thank you all for coming to the Franklin R. Shirley. First, let's give our judges a nice round of applause. Right. Check that one more time. The winner on a 3-2 decision is the negative from Northwestern. In second place, a nice big round of applause for Harvard. And in first place, Northwestern!
Which is that there's one court case context in which it's interpreted that way, and it's not like a universal norm. I think what is sort of persuasive to me, however, is sort of the limits articulation. I guess the biggest issue for me is it's a question of, have you accessed an internal link to fairness? And I think in a world where the interpretation is somewhat arbitrary, that sort of goes away a little bit. My big issue is I think you're going from the wrong link to limits against this particular app. I think that this app is not as abusive because it happens in the future, per se, because I don't know what the bright line is between 2020 2020 and today. I think that the reason why this app is abusive and should be rejected on topicality grounds is because of the literary imaginary framework that sort of becomes like a link argument that in the background of the 2NR that I think would have been a lot more persuasive. Sort of the second thing I'll add also is I think that the 2NR needs to reconsider and isolate offense sort of against this literary imagination argument, right? So the 2AR and the 1AR are making a lot of their offense on this sort of meta-level uniqueness claim for one, that all debate is science fiction, and so we should just incorporate and approach it from that angle. And secondly, that's a sort of prerequisite for effective political efficacy from it. I think more articulate offense for why that's a problematic framework, and why, you know, basic defensive arguments for why it doesn't, like, prevent deliberation and communication from occurring, slash reasons why it may accelerate it would have been helpful. But for the most part, a lot of what Sarah said spoke to me a little bit. Yeah, that's basically all I have to add. I'll let these three talk.
Let me add one more thing to that about the question of all debate is fictional imagination of the future. I just don't understand. I think you need to give examples of why apps that meet, like topical apps, right, aren't fictional imaginations of the future, right?
Well, they're not of the future.
Yeah, they are. I mean, like, does your app happen right now? Like now? But it's always in the future, right?
Probably. That's good. Okay.
Like today, tomorrow, one week from now? I mean, like, how far in the future, right?
Doesn't that seem like it's like, still like moving the goalposts a little more?
Well, they don't have to set up goalposts, right?
Well, no, but that's sort of impact of reasonability.
Well, I guess, I think all apps are in the future, I guess. Unless it's like, about the past. Right, a counterfactual app, right? Because there's no such, I mean, I don't know, maybe this is just my understanding of time. Like, there's no, like, you never, like, pin down the present, you know? It's like, when is the present? Now? Well, that's not the past, right?
It's not how I think about DA links, but gotcha.
Well, no, your DA links are about the future, right? Like, immigration reform, is that happening right now? Or in a couple of years?
But it's, okay.
You know, like,
yeah,
I mean, I don't know. It just seems like everything's about imagination about the future and how that future, I think you need a limit about how far in the future. Also, maybe aliens, right? Is not like a realistic future that you can be prepared for. Or like maybe say, like, we don't have to say space weapons good or something. Or I don't know, bad, I'm not quite sure, right? Which way it goes? I mean, the question of which future is important, right? And also maybe dystopia. They have to be a utopia because they're aft, not a dystopia, I don't know. But.
I think my decision will be kind of quick. I actually voted on this kind of old school fairness DA. I think that you're in trouble. I think that the neg is really winning the claim that debate is more a game than anything else. And I think that their best argument for this is, you know, if debate was about political subjectivity, you probably would have disclosed, so we would have had a more informed debate. And I know you have some arguments about that, but I do think that that proves that debate is more of a game than it is about political subjectivity. And if that's the case, then I think that fairness is a value that should be pursued. And I don't think you have the best answers to fairness. I'll kind of talk about the ones that I have on the flow. Like, the 2NR is very fairness heavy. Like, that's the majority of the top of his 2NR impact calc. And I think the 2AR kind of brushes it off a little bit too much. You say that debate, you said that there's no reason why fairness is important in the 2NR and that it's debate's not a marathon. If debate is a game, then I think fairness is an important value that we should try to achieve. You say that will never be equal at all times. And I agree, and I think his response is that doesn't mean that it's not something that we should look for and try to accomplish as much as possible. You say that then your next argument is just if debate is a game, that doesn't mean it can't have political value, and I agree, but I think if the ultimate value of debate is the competitive aspect, then I think that fairness is something that should be maintained. Ultimately, so that kind of brings up the question of the violation, obviously, to determine the level of fairness that they reach. And I think that there is so two things. I think, first of all, the definition that you probably don't meet is what the 2NR says about U.S. Armed Forces, about it being what they are now. And you just say I don't know how we violate this.
Yeah, it's like a line at the bottom of the 200.
Yeah, he said you don't.
He said U.S. Armed Forces. I don't know. It's the Army Navy.
He said
and...
as it is now. He said in the present. I have that on my flow. I mean that's one
right,
that's one argument. If you want a definition that I don't think you meet, the second is
wait, how do we not meet that if we said U.S. Armed Forces in the plaintext?
Because you're talking about a different armed forces.
That just means we don't solve nothing.
That
we
just
don't
means
meet.
They change something, right?
Yeah.
Like fiat change the status quo, right?
I don't think you're talking about the armed forces that they're defining as what they are now.
But we said armed forces, which
but
means if they define the phrase armed forces.
But you are
what does that
you are recharacterizing the app as not being status quo armed forces.
It's a T argument.
Yeah. Well, okay. The second part of this is the second part of this is I think ultimately it's a question of interpretations, right? They're saying that debate should be about the president. You're saying no, it shouldn't. And so ultimately,
what textual basis do they have for that interpretation?
I think U.S. Armed Forces. I also think they have this should definition,
can
which
you read me
even
the,
if it's not great. Look, I think that they have an argument about why I should why the neg should not have to be prepared about debates in the future, and I think that's compelling.
So you just grasp that card doesn't even say U.S. Armed Forces in the present.
Look,
it just says
I think there's a difference between the negative, like the negative has definitions to kind of prove the textual basis of their interpretations, but I still think that their interpretation is something that I should evaluate versus your interpretation. I think you have a worse interpretation.
What is so their interpretation is just present?
Yeah.
So the app has to be in the status quo, is what you're saying?
Obviously, that can be a change, but it has to happen in the present.
Yeah.
But how do you evaluate those differentiations in time? I mean, maybe this is a...
Yeah, I mean, I think that you and I dropped the argument that all debate... It, as Sarah said, all debate is science fiction. Yeah, maybe silly,
look,
I don't know.
So I think that argument to me is more of a reason why fairness shouldn't be prioritized.
How? What?
Okay,
it's
your argument is that debate is science fiction now, and that you should make it about better science fiction, right? I.e., we learn better. We learn more things. I think if fairness is at first, I haven't even talked about how I think fairness frames that,
fiction,
which is rigorous testing and informed decision making.
If it can't be science fiction, then there's no uniqueness for any of the arguments.
They say you can't be future science fiction. They're like, look, even if part of debate is science fiction, it's better to talk about it in a way that the neg can predict and debate about. I don't understand. It seemed pretty clear to me.
Okay.
The neg is like, we should debate about the present, and you're like, no, we shouldn't, and I think that we should. I'm confused what you're confused about.
Yeah. Okay.
We'll hear everyone.
I don't want
to
hold up.
Anyways, just to wrap it up, I think that the terminal impact to fairness ultimately turns a lot of your offense, which is rigorous testing, preparation of the neg to be able to clash and learn.
I actually agree on a lot with what Sarah said. I think that there is something going on with me about the question of time. What does that mean? Seems a little infinitely regressive. I think that what I need from you guys is, first of all, I obviously agree with you that she's had intelligence are quite problematic in a lot of ways. But what I think I need from you is more than world is an unfair place. I need something about what kinds of specific exclusions are unacceptable to us. I hear you referencing the problems going on in the debate community. I think it's a little too quick, right? I don't think that you're really weighing them against, like I said, they're going all in on contingent limits. So I need something about what is unacceptable, right? How is this argument unacceptable? What does it do to the community at large versus here, whatever, right? The other question that I have is, I mean, I feel your science, I actually really like that, but I feel your science fiction argument. What I don't understand is why does your reading your science fiction and what integrating science fiction into debate can do for us, why does that work? What is the internal link between that and we are not going to defend the implementation or plan right now, right?
What do you mean? I mean, we said we would defend the implementation of the plan, but the part of the like science fiction aspect is it just like doesn't happen now because it's
in
the future.
I have you saying saying in the, I have you saying in the process the plan happens in the future.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean we don't. So you think that? So you the way you interpret that was the plan happens in the future, therefore we don't defend the implementation of it. I mean, I feel like in the 2AR and the 1AR and the 2AC, like, basically every time they ask, "What will you defend implementation?" We're like, yeah. You can read, like, a DA to the plan. It just has to link. You know, it has to, I don't know. Like, reading a hedge DA about, like, you know, Starship Troopers doesn't make any sense. But, I don't know. Yeah.
You can explain it to me more.
Yeah, no, that's reasonable. I if it
I
just didn't get across, it's
yeah,
fair.
Maybe that's a lack of clarification
yeah
on my part.
I think
in that case, maybe
bad communication is fair.
What?
Oh,
yeah. I wrote something else. I can't read my handwriting. It's not like Northwestern.
Where's mine?
I will say, I think one way to deal with the confusion, I think, maybe is to give examples of other apps a little more, right?
Yeah.
And how they're about the future.
Yeah,
something that would have indicated to me what I do gut check feel like is a ludicrous interpretation.
Could you just give me an example of one?
The Supreme Court should overrule Korematsu.
And all decisions are released in German.
Like, that has to do with the future, I think, to me. Also, like, I mean, I don't know. I mean, it's just a question of scale to the future, right?
I'm not even trying to argue. I'm really just trying to understand the argument a little bit.
Or, like, anything. I mean, like, I really think any app is about the future that is saying, like, do something. Like, we want to change the present status quo. Do something else later. Right? Later than right now.
Yeah, I mean, I guess part of my difficulty with both of y'all's decisions so far is, I mean, we made this argument, you know, all traditional apps are science fiction in and of themselves. The 200 just, you know, just doesn't go to it. How does that not?
Okay.
Oh, you got something?
Well, yeah, I disagree. I think that he definitely says that debate fiction assumes, or in his. He does answer your argument that all debate is science fiction. It says that the substantive aspect of science fiction is irrelevant absent predictability. So in thinking about... Okay, you're looking at me funny.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah,
in thinking about this, I kind of framed another question like, what should they do if they've never seen science or Starship Troopers? So his argument about how things intersect within the box, although not the best analogy, right, the idea of some predictable limits to enable clash is necessary. So you have this argument about unpredictability, you know, with like a generic like keep advancing things. I don't think that your unpredictability argument is necessarily connected to your science fiction argument. So if you made an argument about that confrontation with dystopia as an aspect of that unpredictability and why it's good, I think that would be a interesting persuasive argument. Back it up. I think that should is immediate, and you have two links. One is the CX, or they have two links to this. One is the CX argument that Amber mentioned. The other is, I think, the no link on the DA. Your words are, they don't, it doesn't have anything to do with the F. They affirm things as happening now, which to me,
I agree
felt like,
to that, are you?
Okay.
Yeah.
Well,
we
so
future.
I think, I don't think that it is predictable for them to have an in-depth knowledge of science fiction in order, or an in-depth knowledge of Starship Troopers to be able to I think that your Romanelli evidence, right, about Animal Farm in 1984 and how those discussions are good, assumes that all sides have engaged 1984 in Animal Farm. So if you were to read NAF, like, on last year's topic about the mill and Boxer and the tragic nature of the human condition, and they're like, we haven't read Animal Farm, how do you have a debate?
I guess my question is, okay, so one of the things I ask of you in the 2AR, is to sort of flip the script. Like, imagine we had read a policy app and they had made the same T argument. And the app that, like, we haven't read the white paper that your app is about, I don't think you would find that a particular particularly
well,
persuasive
that,
argument, and that's the preconditions for debate somehow.
Their broader arguments about war powers and what's going on now is, I think that a drone white paper is different than a metaphor about Starship Troopers.
How have they established that difference?
Well,
we've explicitly collapsed that difference with our, you know, science fiction.
Right.
Everything science
with
fiction.
With their discussion of.
And they, what are they?
I think that the kind of should is immediate argument about discussions of current structure rather than this future.
I understand that they have like an interpretational, maybe like an interpretational sort of division. I'm asking, like, we're saying they're literally the same thing, so and so, you know, in the 2IR once again, I'm saying treat them as the same thing. If we had made an argument about this, like, RF is about some text.
If you've been, like, playing in a vacuum the whole debate, like, yeah, right now, then I think it's a different story. But there's this whole assumption that they're talking about, which is, like, y'all are talking about United States federal government that currently doesn't, it is the federal government that does the plan in Washington, D.C., and then makes these arguments about kind of the unpredictability of when do things happen. I don't think that the basement analogy, which you're responding to, is the best, but not all of these things are rooted in the literature, so your only argument is like lit checks, but come on.
Why doesn't lit check?
Because the literature that you all are referring to is about Starship Troopers, right? What if they haven't seen...
It's about war powers.
I am not totally convinced.
Okay, you don't have to believe it. I believe me in the abstract.
So,
yeah.
Continuing, I think they have an argument from the Lundberg evidence, right, and the Steinberg evidence, which I don't think that you need an unpredictable form of science fiction to solve those impacts, and that deliberative structures are important. So Amber's observation about like what are the problematic practices that are happening in debate, right? There's just this observation in the 2AR that like debate is dying, but why? Because like why? Like if you can clearly prove why debate is dying based on what they did, I think I'm much more persuaded by the necessity of science fiction. But I don't think that you establish the absolute necessity of your method for engaging debate.
So when we say that the reason why there's sort of destructive practices of debate that enforce, you know, particular kinds of limits and predictability, and then say that they have sort of like performatively done this by continuing to move the goalposts. First it's T, and then when it's clear that we don't really link to T, that they say UF's bad, or they say, you know, this narrower, always narrow, and that's our race to the bottom argument. How is that not exactly what you're asking for?
I don't necessarily agree with that observation.
Yeah, I don't think they were nearly as moving the goalposts as you like. The 1 in C has a few definitions, and then the 2 in R goes for one of those definitions as a violation.
No, they read the new one and the 1 in
R.
The one I'm talking about is
so between the two should interpretations in their defense, right? The context of the first piece of evidence implies this question of immediacy, and then you're like, your app doesn't say that, so like, all right, we'll read another card in this question.
And the whole disclosure thing, sorry, just really quickly, was not a you have to disclose. It was, I understood it as disclosure proves that your impacts are subservient to debate being a game.
Well, I guess, can I just ask this question? How do you see a negative ballot resolving the unpredictability if all debate is science fictional, sort of by definition? How does it resolve the temporal bright line, I guess, between like the okay future app and the unfair future app?
Okay, so I had a lot of debate, all debate is science fiction. I didn't have nearly as much or any of all debate is future. And I understand that there's an element of science fiction that is futuristic, but I don't think that's all that science fiction is. So I understood it as...
I mean, that's what Spider said. Did you really think they said that at all?
I'm sorry? Do I think that they said that? I'm saying I didn't hear you say, well, yeah, true, but I didn't hear you say all debate is futuristic, and I also think that there's still a meaningful distinction between the types of debate that they're saying the next should be prepared for and then the sometime indefinite in the future that we have no idea what it is.
It's more just like how do you determine the bright line for which ones they should prepare for, right? Because you like you can't just have a list of like these are the movies
so,
that you shouldn't have
so
to watch before you
okay,
come into
so
a debate, right? Because like
might,
those are too far
yeah,
in the future.
That,
you know?
That wasn't
like,
part of my RFD.
I was like, how do you establish
like
that
you,
bright line?
You make some arguments about how what types of ground they have. None of it is in negation to the plan text. And their argument is that...
Whoa. I did say they could have read a DA to the plan text, but they didn't. Well, they did, and it didn't link, and that's
like
not our fault.
They could have read a better DA, but...
Most of your stuff was like, our method is bad, and their argument is we need to be able to research the policy, and people don't research about hypothetical science... People don't write dissads to hypothetical science fiction plan text.
So I think
dissads
to
hypothetical plan text,
right?
Because
yes. All plan...
Literature
about they're all speculative.
Well.
That's our argument.
So, Suo, I think that
I don't understand
what you just said... what is important is the question of what if they haven't seen Starship Troopers? So the examples of ground that you give, right, they could have said our story was bad, or they could have said that science fiction is bad, and those are the portions of offense, the extra totality arguments they have about how you're leveraging the ground that you give and the access to the plane based off of the method and things external.
So saying that they have K ground is a link
to
their
tier. They have an argument throughout the debate that the advantages to the plan come after the assessment of
what.
Well,
how did you feel about my argument?
Just have to be top.
Yeah, like we could have said that the advantage. You could have said plan focus. You don't get access to those
advantages.
Advantages
have to be topical because they're relevant to whether or not you evaluate the advantages as dissets to topicality. I don't think that advantages have to be topical.
Okay,
I think
that
need to be stemmed from the plan.
I think the better example that y'all should use is like MSU's app is actually honestly kind of similar, right? It's restricting the authority of the president to enter into forces. They break a new advantage every debate, right? Yeah, you haven't read about whatever stupid shit that they read is their advantage, right? That doesn't mean that it's unpredictable because you didn't know about Estonian democracy or something, right?
Yeah.
But they still have links to the plan, right? And
MSU's restriction happens now, though. It's a restriction that
doesn't happen now. It happens in a sort of arbitrarily displaced future.
The introduction of armed forces might happen later, but the restriction happens now.
I think you should say authority is always about actions that happen in the future, right? It's not like the president is going to enter into force now, right? It's about...
Amber, if we make this future argument clearer, do you think that sways your decision more? This question of the,
I think that if you, like what Sarah was saying, if you give examples such as this thing in the future or how everyone, their answer to politics is always like, well, the plan doesn't get released until June, so you don't get a politics DA. I think that those are examples rather than just like, well, we have this Oxford dictionary,
I mean, I kind of think it's where, the burden's on us to provide all these examples. They kind of just appeal to, hey, present. And then that's
right.
It. You just sort of anthemize all of that.
Well, Zeke's understanding of their interpret was like, well, that's about one court case, but I am just more persuaded by the Summers evidence than Ziegler is, and that's the distinction. So
bear in mind, it's not a gut check either. This is about 45 seconds of the 2NR of just limits explosion for future, right? I'm just persuaded by the argument that there's not an end. Contextual interpretation card to support that.
Yeah.
Hence no violation, hence no internal link to fairness, right? Whereas I think maybe that's the difference between those that voted for Northwestern in this debate and myself.
Yeah.
I understand definitions as proving that your interpretation is predictable, ultimately, and I think that their interpretation is predictable.
That's a question, I guess. If the definition they read does not mention present, but then you voted on that it was present, how is that a predictable interpretation? That's an argument I made at the very bottom.
Well,
I
know I'm kind of talking about two different definitions. What I was just saying there is the definition of should. Even if you're like, this card is not nearly as good as our card, it proves that their interpretation of present is a predictable one.
No, I literally said it wasn't predictable because it's the context of a single court case.
Okay, I think a should equals present is pretty.
I understand that you think it's predictable, like in the abstract. I'm saying that the piece of evidence that they have used to establish the.
I think their evidence proves that it is a predictable interpretation of the word should, because it's that's the way the word gets used.
It literally doesn't.
Mean I should go to the supermarket. Doesn't mean I'm already at the.
That
supermarket.
That card literally says we should not look to the plain meaning of should. We should look to its context within. Like this one legal sort of like thing that's appended to the end of should, and that means present as opposed to the future. And I thought I pointed out like how crazy that interpretation was.
I think that combined with a definition of U.S. Armed Forces.
That U.S. Armed Forces are just talking about the present. Okay.
I think we're not anymore.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you all.
Thanks everyone.
Very much. We appreciate your time.
Yeah, wait.